Move with Tiger Moving Company.
Welcome back into the countdown to first pitch, brought to you by Blue Force Health Plan of South Carolina. Don't forget, fans, if every strikeout by Clemson pitching here today will be brought to you by Hyundai. Hyundai hits your journey on every mile in a brand new Hyundai in all postseason baseball. Here on the network, being brought to you by our good friends at Upcountry Fiber. Time for our South Carolina Department of Agriculture pregame interview with head coach Eric Backus. Able to catch up with coach here prior to the game. Here's my conversation with Coach Backus.
All right, Coach. First of all, obviously, a lot of momentum coming into this regional. Great wins in the ACC tournament, but those aren't going to help you here today. You got to come out here, be ready to go.
Yeah, new tournament, new challenge, great opportunity for our team, and looking forward to today. This is an excellent Lipscomb team, and we'll have to play well in order to come out on top.
All right, tell me a little bit about them, first of all, offensively, what you see from them on tape, what you feel like they're going to try to do to you.
Just a balanced attack, you know. It's 106 home runs, 99 stolen bases, they bunt, they safety, they steal, they run first and third plays, they hit homers, they got four guys with, 15 to 21 home runs, so they are a dual threat, multi-threat type of offense, and then we're facing the Atlantic Sun Pitcher of the Year. So we are absolutely going to have our hands full today and know it's going to be a great game.
Well, the other thing is this offensively, your club just needs to kind of keep on doing what they have been doing. I mean, it's been very remarkable to watch this ball club the last 20 to 30 ball games, which you all have been able to do.
Yeah, I like our team too. So, we also have multiple threats. We've got speed and power. So, yeah, we'll just keep stringing quality at-bats together, keep that lineup connected, 1 through 9, keep those QABs coming and the run scoring happening at a high pace. And when our guys are focused on scoring runs, getting on base, and knowing they have a job to do until they cross home plate, it's usually a good day for the offense. So we'll stick with that.
All right, Austin Gordon, how does he need to go out there and attack these guys?
He just needs to attack them. I mean, they're watching them on film. The teams who have not had success against these guys have had more of a nibble approach, and you can't nibble when you got teams that can hit for power. You just got to go after them, and sometimes the best thing you can do is just get to strike two as quick as you can. And so Gordo needs to do that. He just needs to be in attack mode. He needs to go right at him, trust his stuff, and let that defense play behind him. So we're not going to nibble. We may pitch around one guy in their lineup, the Kelly guy who's got 21 home runs, but outside of that, we're just going to be in attack mode, and we're going to go get them, and we're going to collect outs when they do bunt or safety or whatever they do, and do our best to hold the running game. But it's a good team, and we're excited for the challenge, but we're up for it too.
Playing a home regional, one, crowd needs to be there behind you. Two, you need to be able to feed off the energy that they generate.
Yeah, it's great when there's synergy, when our play energizes the crowd and when the crowd energizes our players, then I think you got a good recipe for success, and that's what we need. We need the crowd into it, need them loud, need them waving those balloons, need them doing everything they can do to create themselves and insert themselves into this game as the 10th player. And if we can do that, I think that that will be something that maybe hasn't been seen here in a while. Maybe it's, bits you've seen glimpses of it. But if we can get all 9 innings of it and all weekend of it, I think that would be awesome.
Final question for you, the decision to play the 1 o'clock game, just to give your opportunity, get a little bit more rest heading towards Saturday?
Well, we had to make the decision like a month ago when we first bid for a regional. You got to put in your preference time. So we, just thought it would be strategic to just in case there was weather. Been in regionals before where you have weather delays and when you're that second game and you could end up playing well into the middle of the night, past midnight, or have to come and play a doubleheader on Saturday. We just felt like, just attack it and go get it and get game one in. And then, there is an opportunity for extended rest as well. But more importantly, just make sure we get game one in on day one.
Solid Orange Friday. Let's go get a win.
Let's do it. Go Tigers.
So there you go, our pregame interview with head coach Eric Backett, presented by the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. A certified South Carolina program helps South Carolinians find and buy locally sourced food from farmers. To find South Carolina-grown products, including local farms, visit CertifiedSC.com. That's CertifiedSC.com. All right, we'll come back. We'll take a look at starting lineups. Bat and more as we continue to count it down to the first pitch in this Clemson Regional. Lipscomb, the first opponent for our Clemson Tigers. We'll be back with more of the countdown to the first pitch. Brought to you by Blue Choice Health Plan of South Carolina after this on the Clemson Athletic Network.
Clemson can feel like something we can't do anything about, but we can. There are screening tests that can catch cancer early when it may be easier to treat. Begin cervical screening at age 25. At 45, start colorectal and breast screening. At 50, discuss lung screening with a doctor. Find resources for free and low-cost screening at cancer.org/screen. This is a public service message from the American Cancer Society.
And now, an important message from Jerry Rice.
As a career wide receiver, I've been hit all the time. But no training nor practice prepared us for the devastation of COVID-19. Thankfully, there is hope. Even with multiple vaccines available, we still have to work together until everyone is safe. We all win when we unite to prevent.
For more information, visit unitetoprevent.org. And now, an important message from Steve Harvey.
This pandemic is over. We got the vaccine. I got mine. You might have yours. But listen to this. Don't think just because you got the vaccine that you can just go crazy. Follow the current safety guidelines. I know the mask is hot, but you know what's hotter than these masks? Staying healthy. That's pretty fly, if you ask me. Let's unite to prevent.
For more information, visit unitetoprevent.org.
Data shows that after a child turns 9 in foster care, they are much less likely to be adopted. But the Dave Thomas Foundation for Adoption believes every child is adoptable.
Families, if you're able to let your hair down a little bit, there's a lot to learn from teenagers.
The clock is ticking for teens at risk of aging out of foster care. Learn how you can help at DaveThomasFoundation.org.
Back on the countdown to first pitch, brought to you by Blue Choice Health Plan of South Carolina. Remember, they offer a variety of health and dental plans to serve the needs of all South Carolinians. You can learn more at BlueChoiceSC.com. Focus on life, focus on health, stay focused. Starting lineup, Bob Mahoney's got that taken care of.
Right, I do. Game one of this Clemson Regional 2023. Excitement within Doug Kingsmore Stadium as the Tigers face the Lipscomb Bison, who come into the ball game 36-24 as the visiting team. Caleb Patrick will lead it off. He'll start at shortstop. Batting second will be the center fielder, Alex Vergara. Batting third, playing first base, Mason Lundgren. Batting cleanup will be the third baseman, Trace Wilhoy. Batting fifth will be Austin Kelly. He'll start behind the plate for the Bison. Jake Bird will bat sixth. He'll start in left field. Batting seventh will be the designated hitter, Parks Vaught. Batting eighth, starting at second base, David Coppedge. And in batting ninth will be the right fielder, Will Lee. So once again, for Lipscomb, the lineup will be like this. Ketchum at short, Vergara in center, Lundgren at first. Will Hoyt at third, Kelly behind the plate, Bird in left. Vaught to DH, Coppedge at second, Lee in right field for the Tigers, the home team. Coming to the ballgame, 43-17 overall. Cam Panarella will lead it off. He'll start in center field. Cooper Engel will bat second. He'll be behind the plate. Will Taylor will bat third. He'll start in left. Batting cleanup, the first baseman, Caden Grady. Batting fifth, the designated hitter, Billy Amick. Batting sixth will be the second baseman, Riley Bertram. Batting seventh, starting at third, Blake Wright. Batting eighth will be the shortstop, Ben Blackwell. And batting ninth, starting in right field, Jack Crichton. So once again, for the Tigers, it'll be Panarella in center, Engel behind the plate, Taylor in left. Bryce at first, Amick to DH, Bertram at second. Wright at third, Blackwell at short, and Crichton in right field. Pitching matchup for this afternoon's ball game. first for the Bison of Lipscomb. They will send junior left-hander Logan Van Creek to the mound. He is 6'5", 220 from Lincoln, Nebraska, and comes into this ballgame 8-4 with a 3.5 ERA. The Tigers will send sophomore right-hander Austin Gordon to the mound. Austin is 6'4", 200 from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and he comes into the ballgame with a 2-4 record, a 4.41 ERA. Umpires for this afternoon's ballgame, Angel Campos will be behind the plate at first base. Bill McGuire at second base, Dave Condon, and over at third base, it'll be Eddie Newsom. Game one of this Clemson Regional.
Thank you very much, Bob. Hey, don't forget, fans, next time you come into Clemson for a game, stay in the university's own James F. Martin, part of the Conference Center and Inn Complex. The Inn has 89 boutique-style rooms and suites that overlook Lake Hartwell and the Walker Golf Course. If you need more information, you can go to www.stayatclemson.com. Now, obviously, later on in this Clemson Regional, we'll have Charlotte and Tennessee will square off against one another. That will be a first pitch scheduled for 6 o'clock. Other regionals, and there's already action that's begun because we've had some 12 noon starts around the country. One of those is in the Lexington Regional up in Kentucky. Ball State and Kentucky, they are scoreless top of three in that one, with Indiana and West Virginia still to follow. In the Gainesville Regional, where number two Florida resides, Texas Tech with a 1-0 lead over UConn. And that is in the bottom of the third. In that one, Florida A&M and Florida still coming up. Bottom of the second at Virginia. Virginia's already off to a 9-0 lead over Army. And that's in the bottom of the second. So Virginia off to a hot start. Oklahoma, East Carolina on the opposite side of that. 1 o'clock starts also include Xavier and Oregon in Nashville, Washington, Dallas Baptist, and Stillwater, Oklahoma. And the Winston-Salem Regional, you'll have Northeastern and Maryland at 1 o'clock. George Mason and Wake will follow at 7. Down in Columbia, NC State and Campbell will first pitch at 1 o'clock. In Conway, it'll be Wilmington and Duke first pitching at 1 o'clock. At Terre Haute, the Indiana State Regional, Wright State and Indiana State will first pitch at 1 o'clock. Then at 2 o'clock, down in Coral Gables, Louisiana and Texas will square off. Maine and Miami will follow at 7 o'clock. At the Auburn Regional, which is the regional that this regional is squared up against, Stanford and Southern Miss will first pitch at 2 o'clock, with Penn and Auburn to go at 7 o'clock. Fayetteville Regional will see Santa Clara and Arkansas at 3. Also at 3, Troy and Boston College in Tuscaloosa. Tulane and LSU at 3 o'clock in Baton Rouge. And then at 5 o'clock on the West Coast, in the Stanford Regional, San Jose State and Stanford will go. Cal State Fullerton and Texas A&M will be the final games that will wrap up NCAA play today. So we got a bunch of baseball that's going on. There's going to be a number one or two or three seed that's going to get upset today somewhere along this line. Hopefully it's not going to take place, but I guarantee you somewhere a number one is going to fall. I would almost guarantee
college baseball happens.
Yeah. Somebody's always got great pitching, and great pitching usually takes care of dominant offense from that standpoint. Stations, 10 seconds for station identification here on the Clemson Athletic Network. We're going through the starting lineup for our Clemson Tigers as every member of the team will get introduced. Only a 27-man roster in NCAA play, so vastly different from what it is in the ACC, where you had an unlimited roster that could travel in 30 of the ACC tournament. It's been trimmed to 27, and that's the way it will stay from here on out until a national champion is crowned. Great crowd has already shown up here at 1 o'clock on a Friday to come out and support the Clemson Tigers. This is going to be very electric, and you let this team get going early, the roof might just come off this place. Let's hope that is indeed the case. Standing room only expected here today. And before we go any further, while we take our last break, we will do that. And we will take a break, come back, first pitch. We'll do that after this. Here on the Clemson Athletic Network.
And we're back with breaking news. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any Coke can. So make sure you...
ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals. The exclusive home of the complete 30 for 30 library. Exclusive access. Top leagues and tournaments. And the biggest names in the game. ESPN Plus. Live sports. Thousands of live events. ESPN Plus Originals.
Welcome to the NCAA Baseball Regionals presented by Capital One. Game number one of the Clemson Regional, the number four national seed Tigers, fresh off an ACC tournament championship. Play host to the A-Sun regular season and tournament champs, the Lipscomb Bisons, as we get set for a busy day of baseball here. The ball may be flying. Three of the top home run hitting teams in the country, highlighted by Tennessee and Charlotte, the nation's home run leader on ESPNU tonight at 6 o'clock Eastern. Welcome, everybody. Tom Hart alongside Kyle Peterson. Clemson comes into the postseason. One of the best stories in the entire game. They turned their season around. They're now riding a 16-game hit streak, and Eric Backage's team is playing with a ton of confidence.
Yeah, it was the best of times. It was the worst of times. I think somebody wrote that in a book one time, and it was kind of Clemson's season. First 30, they weren't going to make the NCAA tournament. Forget about playing at home. Last 30, there's an argument to be made that they're playing as good as anybody in the entire nation. Obviously, offensively, some things changed. But it's an older team, and when you talk to Eric Backage, his feedback was, listen, they just kept doing what we asked them to do. Well, what they've asked them to do is win 26 of their last 30 and had the opportunity to play at home in the postseason.
They didn't lose a game in Durham at the ACC tournament. Meanwhile, Lipscomb's hit 106 home runs. That's 14th best in the nation. And this guy, their catcher, Austin Kelly, has got 21 of them.
Yeah, there's some thump in this lineup. Four of them with at least 16 home runs, and this is a ballpark that's going to lend itself to home runs. You just feel like if Lipscomb is going to make a run through this thing and have a chance to be playing on Sunday or Monday, they're going to have to hit the ball out of the ballpark.
See a couple of aces on the mound for game one of our Clemson Regional. Austin Gordon for Clemson and Logan Ventrick gets the ball for Lipscomb. We'll have first pitch and look at the starting lineups right after this.
Massage the burger with olive oil, basting every 20 minutes to keep it from drying out. And voila.
This gonna taste all right.
Popcorn and savings. Just like bundling your home and car with Geico.
Whoa!
Hey, I know you.
Yeah, hi.
Not you. The guy who helped me bundle my home and car. He's great.
Probably thought you were somebody else.
Geico.
This isn't Charmin. No wonder I don't feel as clean.
Hurry up, Dad.
You've been in there forever.
I'm trying. This cheap stuff is too thin.
I told you not to get the other toilet paper.
Here's Charmin Ultra Strong.
Ah, my bottom's been saved. Woohoo!
With its diamond weave texture, Charmin Ultra Strong cleans better with fewer sheets and less effort.
What's everybody waiting for? This?
Okay, hon. We know you're clean. We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
That's a pretty tight spot.
Watch this.
Your Buick parks itself. That's so you.
Of course you know where we're going. That's so you.
Kind of got a sixth sense.
And a head-up display.
They're here.
At the heart of every Buick SUV is you.
Get 2.49% APR and no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get $750 purchase allowance on 2023 Buick Encore GX models.
YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable. And more is an especially good thing to have if you love basketball. We just hope you can handle this much of it. Watch more games at once with MultiView on YouTube TV. YouTube TV, it's more than cable for $600 less than cable. Try it for free.
Is that KFC chicken sandwich spicy?
Sinfully.
I'd do anything for one.
Anything.
Gotcha, one.
Order any KFC sandwich online till July 2nd for Diablo 4 rewards.
We get going with the first game of this Clemson Regional. Here's a look at the Bison's batting order for this Lipscomb team, which hit 106 home runs and set a new school record. They lead off with the all-conference shortstop Caleb Ketchup. He's got 16 home runs. Just pop all the way through this batting order.
They can run it out of the ballpark, and that's going to be the biggest thing, I think, to watch for all four of these teams this weekend. Home runs up across the board, but definitely up in this regional. Austin Gordon gets a start, 16th this year. He hasn't missed a turn the entire year. Low 90s, three different breaking balls. I think one thing to watch today is you feel like it's a Lipscomb lineup that's going to try to elevate everything, try to get the ball in the air. Not a bad day to keep it on the ground today.
Won his game against BC in the ACC tournament. Allowed only two hits and didn't allow a run over six innings. And avenged his most recent loss. It's a warm one today. Temperature right now, 82 degrees. It'll keep climbing up to the upper 80s before it starts going the other way. And we get a 6 o'clock start for game number two between Tennessee and Charlotte. Wind doesn't seem to be much of a factor at the moment, but if it starts blowing out, this park can get small in a hurry. 310 down the left field line, 320 to right, and 390 to straightaway center field. Austin Gordon ready to go, and Caleb Ketchup will get us started. Lipscomb led by head coach Jeff Forehand in his 17th season. Last 2 years, he's been the A-Sun Coach of the Year. And he's had Ketchup as part of his lineup. The last couple of years, second-team all-conference selection on the all-tournament team. Homer twice in the tournament, including one Sunday against Florida Gulf Coast. And we are underway with a first pitch strike. 92-mile-an-hour fastball from Austin Gordon. Product of Myrtle Beach, Myrtle Beach High School. Yeah. 92 again.
Pretty good place to live right there. Outside black right at the knees.
Ketchup started his college career at Georgia. The curveball's chopped into the dirt. He's an Atlanta native out of Holy Innocence. He has started every game at short this year. He has led off every game for Lipscomb.
They got a shortstop with an OPS above 900. 16 home runs, and he's 30 for 35 in stolen bases.
Breaking ball hit to short. Benjamin Blackwell is there. Throw wide, and it goes all the way to the dugout fencing. Ketchup will get back to the bag. Eighth error of the season for the Clemson shortstop, Benjamin Blackwell, and an opportunity for Lipscomb early.
Plenty of time, and just kind of let this one fly. And if you throw it over Grice's hand at first base, that is sailed right there. He goes up and tries to get it, but Ketchup took a few steps towards second base, thought otherwise of it. That is one thing to watch with Lipscomb. They had a ton of home runs, and they are aggressive on the base pass.
Here's Alex Vergara, 278 average with 21 home runs and OPS over 1,000. Cooper Engel is the Clemson catcher. Ketchup not running yet.
And a first pitch fastball again in for a strike. Ketchup 30 for 35. Still not going, and it's fouled off. How aggressive would you be if you were Lipscomb here in the first?
I'd be very aggressive. I think I'd try to set the tone, especially with the guys that can really run, and the guys at the top of this lineup can. 30 to 35 for Ketchup. Vergara 15 to 21. With four in this lineup, a double-digit stolen base is 99 on the year for the Bisons.
Runner goes, ground ball to short, no chance for two. And that throw is on the money from Blackwell. Ketchup in scoring position with one down and Mason Lundgren coming up.
Kind of like that if you're Blackwell. Get another one hit right to you. Can settle your heartbeat a little bit. That one was a perfect throw over to Caden Grice.
Here's Mason Lundgren. He's from Salina, Kansas. Hard off I-70. The first pitch fastball misses up. It's the first time Gordon hasn't delivered a first pitch strike. Lundgren came to Nashville by way of Neosho Community College. Started every game at first this year. Second year as a starter. Pickoff to second. It's a three-time All-State performer at Salina High School. Another try.
That's three picks already. One to first, now two to second. I went to a family reunion in Salina, Kansas one time.
How'd that go?
It was good. Good outdoor, wonderful weather, picnic tables, memorable.
Swing and a miss. Got our minivan breakdown in Salina, Kansas, on our way to a family ski trip. Spent the entire week with a hole in the manifold before it could get it repaired on the way back. Loudest Ford Aerostar ever inside. 2-1.
Oh, Salina.
Lundgren's a big George Strait fan. I wonder if George Strait ever wrote a song about Salina. The answer is no. George isn't a songwriter. He's just a singer. Relies on other people. 3-1 now. Lundgren's homered four times. He's in the three hole for this Lipscomb team. And the count goes full. What are you seeing from Gordon here early?
Fastball command's been pretty good. I like using the bottom part of the zone. That time was exactly where he wanted to throw it. That's strike three. That one caught the plate, and I know it wasn't exactly where Engel wanted it, which is probably when Lundgren had the reaction that he did. Wanted it outside, got it on the inside corner, but that definitely caught the plate. 3-1, two straight fastballs to get his first strike out of the day.
Ketchup reached on a throwing error to start this game. He's at second base after advancing on a ground out. Now Trace Wilhoit up. Out of Scott County High School in Georgetown, Kentucky. He's been the everyday starter at third base this year for the Bisons. 17 home runs. He's driven in 65. Gordon with a check of the pitch watch to get the pitch selection. Did he? One ball, two strikes.
Three fastballs so far has been 90 to 92. This one a little bit more elevated maybe than Gordon wanted, but he got the reaction that he wanted at home plate.
Swing and a miss, and Gordon takes care of business himself after the error. Will Hoyt goes down swinging, and Lipscomb misses an opportunity in the opening frame. Clemson coming to the plate.
The NCAA is instrumental in Team USA's success at the Olympics. At the Summer Games, over 75% of Team USA's athletes competed collegiately, representing over 150 U.S. colleges and universities across Divisions 1, 2, and 3. And now they compete to bring home medals for our nation. The college athlete experience, a building block for success. The NCAA is proud Olympians and Paralympians are made here.
If I just stare at these payroll forms, my business payroll taxes will calculate themselves, right? Nope.
QuickBooks helps you manage your payroll taxes.
Cheers.
Right now, get 70% off for 3 months.
Research shows people remember heartwarming ads. So to help you remember that Liberty Mutual customizes your home insurance, here's a touching moment.
I want to give you something very special that I wore on my wedding day.
Liberty Mutual customizes your home insurance so you only pay for what you need. I love you, Mom.
I love you, too.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 Liberty.
Here's a look at the batting order for the Clemson Tigers, third in the ACC in batting average with a 308 mark, but not a ton of power, only 64 home runs. Caden Grice is a two-way star. He's on the John Olerud two-way player of the year finalist list, one of three. Be on the mound at some point this weekend, and oh, by the way, he's also leading the team with 16 home runs. Logan Van Treek gets the ball for Lipscomb, 6'5", 220-pound lefty out of Lincoln, Nebraska. He's the A-Sun pitcher of the year, and this dude fills up the strike zone.
Yeah, he does, and he didn't start in this role. It was a relief role until about a third of the way through a season. His first start went CG3 hitter against Liberty, and he's been in the rotation ever since. 101 strikeouts, 13 walks, low 90s fastball, added a cutter this year, and it really made everything get that much better. But he's turned into a true ace for this Lipscomb team.
Out of Lincoln Southeast High School in Nebraska, the A-Sun pitcher of the year. His junior year with Lipscomb. He was a starter in 21 and half the time in 22. He leads off against the ACC Freshman of the Year, Cam Cannarella. What a year this guy is having. OPS over 1,000. Only one home run his senior year of high school. He's got six his first year in the ACC. And a first pitch strike. Can Van Treek neutralize Clemson?
He has the stuff to do it and the control to do it. Yeah, he absolutely does. Kind of a funky move to home plate. That front side gets a little bit high for Van Treek as he comes in. Then it's not really an arm slot over the top. It's more low three quarters. Not easy to pick it up, especially for left-handed hitters.
Cannarella comes in with a 386 average. That was sixth best in the ACC. And he did a little bit of everything at the ACC tournament. Of his five hits, he tripled twice. He had a double and a home run. And a tag out on the slider swing. One down.
So those were the curveballs. You'll see those for Van Treek. It's primarily fastball that's low 90s. He's been as high as 94, 95 this year, but dipped a little bit more towards the end of the year. A cutter, which we haven't seen yet. And that big loop and breaking ball that's about a 20-mile-an-hour difference between the fastball. Back-to-back for the freshman right there for the first out.
Here's Cooper Engel. Seven hits in four games as Clemson went 4-0 in Durham. And he offered at that bunt. That's a strike. Engel not so happy about it.
Yeah, I thought he pulled it back. I mean, the first move looked like he was going to go after it. I thought he pulled the bat back, and the Clemson coaching staff did too.
Engel's hitting 50 points higher against lefties than he is righties on the season. 5'10", 190. He's had a couple of really good streaks, both a 19 and a 16-game hitting streak this year. mile-an-hour fastball from the lefty.
Ringo going to go back talk to Angel Campos and go, hey, man, I'm with you the whole game. We got a check swing that wasn't a strike, and that one looked a little low.
Didn't know we'd get an Axel F remix in day number one of the tournament, but here we are. 1-2 to Engel. And he slashes that one through the left side for a knock. One on, one out for Clemson. In the heart of the order coming up, led by Will Taylor.
Shorten up, put it in play. Left on left, and that's exactly what Cooper Engel did. Choked up just a little bit, shoots it to left, and it's Clemson's first base run.
Taylor, two sports standout, first team all conference in baseball, has won a conference championship in both baseball and football as a wide receiver and kick returner for Dabo. And the first pitch fastball misses a hair low. A home run and four driven in Durham for Taylor. He went 6-for-12 at the plate. Engel dancing over at first. And now the count 2-0. Only two stolen base attempts for Engel on the year. 50% base runner.
There's that big loop and breaking ball in there, just a strike stealer. Haven't really seen the cutter yet, but that one, you're anticipating a 2-0 take on a breaking ball. You got to be able to land it. Van Treek's been able to do that pretty consistently this year.
2-2.
This DJ working overload here.
Yeah, love it.
We got in between pitches music. That's rare.
But appreciated.
Mm-hmm. It's a tip jar in the press box.
Big cut for Taylor, and he goes down swinging. Now for Logan Van Treek, 103 strikeouts against just 13 walks on the year.
But he came back from a 2-0 count. So steals a strike with the breaking ball, then gets back to 2-2, elevates the fastball. Both outs so far for Van Treek have been via the strikeout.
Now for Clemson, Caden Grice. The dude fills up a batter's box, 6'6", 250. Four home runs in the last seven games. And Dunn gets cheated and sends this one deep to center. Vergara at the fence, and it is gone! Two-run home run for Caden Grice. Dude's on a heater. Five home runs in eight games.
Win, no win, ballpark. This one was going out. For Grice, it came off 107 miles an hour off the bat. I think Vergara thought he had a chance at that. He was back to the ball early, and then there was nothing he could do. Hunting first pitch fastball. Caden Grice got it, and Clemson strikes first.
Clemson hosting for the 17th time, fifth in college baseball with their 45th regional appearance. And here's Billy Amick. DH swings at the first and fouls it off. Right off the cap, nothing in one to Amick. Sophomore from Batesburg, South Carolina. Led the ACC in hitting with a .418 clip and a dozen home runs to balance it. Third in the league in slugging. not just first team all conference, but collegiate baseball named him an All-American yesterday. In fact, it's the first time for Clemson that they've had multiple All-Americans on the same team since 18, when that squad had Seth Beer, Logan Davidson, and Riley Gilliam. One and two.
I don't know if I'd go back to that one. He didn't miss that by much. And he's fouled straight back, and Emick was on time, just missed him.
A punch out, the third of the inning, but Caden Grice delivered the big stick with a two-run home run, his 17th of the year. The NCAA Baseball Regionals are presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
I'm your overly competitive brother.
Check.
Psych. And I'm about to steal this game from you, just like I stole Kelly Carter in high school, huh?
You got no game. Dude, that's a foul.
And now you're ready to settle a score. Game over. And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, well, you can end up paying for all this yourself. So get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem. Yeah, like me.
Thanks, bro.
Take a lap, rookie.
Real mature.
I'm coming back on top and I'm living swing, swing, swing. I turn the voltage up, raise the hair on your neck. Cause I was dying from the start. We're powered up.
And a look here at the course Jack built.
Oh my goodness, go in!
Wow. Jack is the man.
Clemson with a 2-0 lead thanks to a Caden Grice home run. Tigers chose to go the early route today, get the first game in. 2 and 3 seeds Tennessee and Charlotte will play in the night game. Great crowd on hand for this one. And you would expect to be a lot of orange in the building tonight. Can I get you a burger, KP?
You can always get me a burger, Tom Hart.
Austin Kelly flies this one to center field. First pitch swinging. And there's one down with left fielder Jake Berg coming to the plate. A handful of hosts have decided to play the first game of the regional, including Kentucky with a 1-0 lead against Ball State. Virginia on top of Army 11-0. That game's in the fourth inning. There's real value in taking the first game time slot, especially if there's any weather indication. But you get a little bit more rest than the team that's going later that night as Berg looks at a first pitch strike.
Yeah, host can set the schedule day one, and then it's always losers first, winners second, losers first, winners second, days two and three. So I think it is an advantage to play first.
Berg lifts it to left. Will Taylor in front of the ramp. Two down. Five straight retired now by Austin Gordon. Great chat with Cooper Engel yesterday about Gordon and what's allowed him to make great improvements. He said he gained some weight. He focused on his release point, but it's really his mental edge and the fact that he's a pitcher that attacks hitters now. He's the fork instead of the spoon.
Thank you, Jack Leggett.
First pitch strike to Parks Bauk, and the count nothing and one. Bauk Sr. out of Keller, Texas, and a soft line drive will drop for a base hit against the shift. They had Bertram playing him to pole, and there's a two-out single.
Yeah, pretty good fastball location, too. It was right on the inside black of the plate. Bauk gets enough to it, playing straight up. Clemson's probably got a chance to make this play. Pulled over to the shortstop side of second base. Riley Bertram can't get there. The Bisons have their first hit of the game.
So here's David Coppedge. He's from Chesterfield, Virginia. Started his college career playing at UVA. Only starter in the batting order for Lipscomb with a batting average under 200. And that fastball just a hair low, 1-1. Not a whole lot of shuffling in starting lineups at this point of the season for most teams. Coppedge, though, started the first 7 games of the season and then the last 6. Getting every one of those starts at second base. Shift on the 2-1 and a breaking ball. Oh, we got a balk. And Bauk will take second base.
I think he just rolled through his set position right there. Gordon just kind of got into almost too much of a rhythm out there on the mound.
Second time in the first 2 innings that Lipscomb has had a runner in scoring position. Left Ketchup stranded at second in the first. Went through and takes a count full, 3-2. Hard hit line drive to left field. Bauk headed around third, and he'll score to get Lipscomb on the board here in the second inning. And an RBI single by David Coppedge.
Well, you said it. Coppedge hit just 197 coming into this game, and it was 2 quick outs to start the inning. One out single by Bauk gets to second on the balk. There's no way he's scoring from first on this one. So standing at second base, able to come around and score easily, and Lipscomb gets one back here after starting the inning with 2 outs, nobody on.
There's a 9-hole hitter, Will Lee. Switch hitter goes from the left side. 6-2, a buck 85. Came to Lipscomb from Wharton County Junior College. He's from Spring, Texas, out of Klein High School. Changeup takes it to nothing and 2. And 3 straight to take care of the 9-hole hitter. But Lipscomb gets a run across thanks to the balk from Gordon. And we got a 2-1 game.
Wow, look at these seats. They're great.
Yeah, kind of thought I had the aisle, but...
Hot nuts, popcorn, bundle and save.
Hot nuts and popcorn and savings. Just like bundling your home and car with Geico.
Yeah, in fact, hot nuts are like home insurance.
I get it. The Gecko explained it pretty clearly.
Whoa! Hey, I know you.
Yeah, hi.
Not you. The guy who helped me bundle my home and car. He's great.
Thanks, mate. I appreciate it.
Probably thought you were somebody else.
Okay.
See how much you could save by bundling with Geico.
YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable. And who doesn't like more? Just ask anyone who loves basketball. And they'll tell you, there's no such thing as too much of it. Watch more games at once with MultiView on YouTube TV. YouTube TV, it's more than cable for $600 less than cable. Try it for free.
That's a pretty tight spot.
Watch this.
Your Buick parks itself. That's so you.
Of course you know where we're going. That's so you.
Kind of got a sixth sense.
And a head-up display.
They're here.
At the heart of every Buick SUV is you.
Get 2.49% APR and no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get $750 purchase allowance on 2023 Buick Encore GX models.
A The on-ramp on the road to Omaha here, where Clemson has finished its season 12 times, but they haven't been since they last won a regional. That was 2010. Under head coach Jack Leggett, saw his number retired this season and is back in the dugout with his former assistant, Eric Backage. He's been to Omaha, took Michigan there 2019. And this guy was on the field for him, Riley Bertram. One of the few Tigers that has postseason experience. Grad transfer, veteran leader. He's from Zionsville, Indiana. Had a great week in Durham, hit 400, homered, drove in six, and he was 6 for 6 on the bases. Backage was talking about Bertram, and he said simply he's a winner. He's got the it factor. Whether that be in baseball or business, I'm going to try and hire him at some point. 4 seasons at Michigan. And I think that postseason experience is incredibly valuable. He's playing in his 13th NCAA tournament game, and he's hit over 400, 405 in the postseason. Now in his second stop with Backage. And it sends a line drive to right. That gets foul. Bertram took the bat all the way with him.
I was looking at the same thing. He still undropped it. He really likes that one.
Well, maybe he was taking a lightsaber with him. Comes from a baseball family. His brother Drew played at Purdue. His other brother Ryan played at Southern Indiana. Off the tape, and this one will find the seats. .280 average on the season. He turned it up in conference play, .312 in ACC games. They started 2-8 in conference. Bertram goes down swinging. That is a fourth strikeout for Logan Ventrique.
Every out retired so far. Done it a few different ways. That time got Bertram all the way out in front on a breaking ball.
ESPN is the home for the NCAA College Baseball Regionals. You can get around-the-clock multi-game coverage by scanning the QR code right there. Take out your phone, open up the camera. Might look silly if you're at a sports bar standing that close to the TV, but give it a try.
It's worth it.
ESPN Plus subscribers can access expanded coverage with Squeeze Play.
Quad boxes galore.
What's the plural of quad boxes?
Quad box eye.
That. Ventrique is the Lipscomb ace, and his one mistake, the fastball to Caden Gricey, hit out of here. What's the staying power for Ventrique sitting at 27 pitches here in the second?
I think it's pretty significant based on what the body of work was. Again, his first start of the year, he went over 110 pitches, CG3 hitter. So he's worked deep into plenty of games.
Into center field. Vergara puts it away, two down. Ventrique had a game against Kennesaw State, his first start in May, where he went 9 innings, allowed just 2 hits and a run with 9 strikeouts. He threw 132 pitches that day.
He's going to get a chance in pro ball, too. I mean, you get a left-hander who's been up to 95, not today. He's been 90, 92 today, but it's kind of that funky action he's got. He's probably going to add something else. Use that cutter a little bit more, but the fastball plays up.
Blackwell drops the bunt down. Charging in is Will Hoyt, and off-balance throw. Too late. And Blackwell surprises everybody with a two-out bunt single.
That was well done. Blackwell maybe not done running yet. Showed pretty early, too. I'm not sure why Will Hoyt's playing that far back. Blackwell's got 25 bags this year, and he's not exactly known for his power, but playing all the way behind at third base, it was kind of a layup if he got it down the right place. Did just beat it by a step, but now Clemson's got a two-out base runner.
Here's Jack Crichton. Fastball inside. Sixteenth start of the season for Crichton. Came on late to take over the right field spot for Clemson. .62 at bats, only three extra base hits. Blackwell's 25 bags, most in the ACC. And that one will be dumped into right field. Blackwell on his way to third. And Crichton keeps the lineup moving and will turn it over. Back-to-back two-out singles. A bunt from Blackwell, and then Crichton with just enough.
And they're not hitting him hard this inning, but hitting it in the right spot. Infield single. This one kind of off the end of the bat for Crichton, but he's now standing on first base. A freshman, Cam Cannarella, coming up with two guys on a two-out.
Cannarella struck out in the first. Second in the ACC in hits with 93 of them. Van Treek needs it out here. He's got Engel, Taylor, then Grice to follow. Breaking ball for a strike. Logan Van Treek was the A-Sun Pitcher of the Year, first in Lipscomb school history to get that honor. Back-to-back breaking balls to Cannarella. A little fake to first. Van Treek finished the season sixth in the country in strikeout-to-walk ratio, fourth in whip, .91. Hasn't issued a walk today. Swing and a miss. Look back to the breaking ball to strike out Cannarella for the second time.
Pretty good work right there. Five strikeouts so far for Logan Van Treek. He's got the freshman Cannarella twice. Two in the books. It's 2-1 Clemson.
I'm your overly competitive brother.
Check.
Psych. And I'm about to steal this game from you, just like I stole Kelly Carter in high school, huh?
You got no game. Dude, that's a foul.
And now you're ready to settle a score. Game over. And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, well, you can end up paying for all this yourself. So get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem. Yeah, like me.
Thanks, bro.
Take a lap, rookie.
Real mature.
Now this is the best idea ever. The all-new Doritos Cool Ranch Papadilla from Papa John's. We put the bold flavors of Doritos Cool Ranch all over our signature flatbread-style sandwich and created the zestiest flavor mashup ever. Oh, and some Doritos Cool Ranch dipping sauce? We thought of that, too. Get the new Doritos Cool Ranch Papadilla before it's gone. Only at Papa John's.
That's a pretty tight spot.
Watch this.
Your Buick parks itself. That's so you.
Of course you know where we're going. That's so you.
I got a sixth sense.
And a head-up display.
They're here.
At the heart of every Buick SUV is you.
Get 2.49% APR and no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get $750 purchase allowance on 2023 Buick Encore GX models.
Kinsmore Stadium in Clemson is the site for game one of the day, game one of this regional. Tom Hart with Kyle Peterson. This Clemson team with a grand tradition, but they hadn't been in the postseason in a few years. They've been to Omaha 12 times and second only to Florida State's 23 in appearances without a national championship. Them, Arkansas, North Carolina have come close. Going to be tough for Northern Colorado to find one.
Yeah. Florida State one's the one that always shocks everybody. Seminoles not in the field for what, first time in 44 years?
Five.
44, 45.
Here's Caleb Ketchup, reached on an error in the first inning. And Ketchup takes a breaking ball to left field for a leadoff single. I feel like we've got two teams in this regional, both wearing orange, Clemson and Tennessee, that could not only make it there, but win it.
I agree. I mean, the odds came out for best chance to win the national championship, and that I saw had Clemson fifth overall out of everybody in the tournament and Tennessee sixth.
Pretty good chances. Here's the center fielder, Alex Vergara. Nate Gordon misses with a first pitch fastball.
Caleb Ketchup, who was in motion when he was on his first at bat, reached second on a ground ball to shortstop. Small lead the first two pitches. And he would expect that he's going to be aggressive on the base pass, may even be a guy that Jeff Forehand just puts on his own, says, you get the jump you want, you go ahead and take it.
And so here's a challenge for Gordon, worried about Ketchup, and he's got the hottest hitter in the Lipscomb lineup at the plate. Vergara homered three times in the A-Sun Championship against Florida Gulf Coast. And that's four home runs over his last two games for this hitter at the plate.
2-0 slider. Gordon's a guy that's about 75% fastball use.
Back to it, 3-1.
That will tell you the confidence that Jeff Forehand, the head coach of this Lipscomb team, has in Vergara right now. 3-0 green light right there. Just fouled off a fastball.
Going to take some of those, right? I mean, for this Lipscomb team to pull off the upset?
Yes. Yeah, it feels like it. But I you know, they look good so far.
Ketchup can't build much of a lead.
Oh, he was moving towards second base when they picked right there. Just wasn't far enough off.
And a shot to the left side. Back-to-back hits to start this third for Lipscomb. And Bison's got something cooking.
Yeah, they do. With a part of the lineup that can do some damage. So leadoff single for Ketchup. He got a slider that he drove to left. This is a 3-1 fastball that Guard does the exact same thing. Two hard hit balls here to start the third, and that'll get Jimmy Bellinger, the pitching coach for Clemson, out of the dugout.
Bellinger was at Florida State last year, first year here with the Tigers, and prior to that at Kentucky with Nick Mangione. Cats in action early on, sixth inning in Lexington, lead Ball State 1-0. Great to see Ball State back in the field.
Ball State gets to experience some dorm life this week.
Uh-huh. Home plate umpires getting into it because Angel Campos just, I think he just charged him with a timeout. And he said, I'm coaching third base. He said, well, you went over and had a meeting. He said, I'm coaching third.
During a visit to the mound. Hey, I want to make sure you're sitting down for this.
Okay.
There's a weather delay in Coral Gables.
Here's the bunt, and that will advance both. Handled by Blake Wright, and a sacrifice from Lundgren. That'll be on your baseball bingo card. Thanks, Rob Anderson. Three-hole hitter puts it down, advances both.
Puts it down in the exact right spot, too. You want to force that third baseman to field this. Vacate the position. Blake Wright has to do just that. So easy for the base runners to move up 90 feet. The Bisons have two in scoring position with the middle of their lineup coming up.
Here's Trace Wilhoit. Wilhoit struck out his first time up. Fouls one back.
See if they stay right there this at bat. That was maybe a tick off the plate, but exactly where Gordon wanted to throw it. Boy, didn't really want it in there. Maybe you bury a slider down and away, see if you can get a chase, then come back with a fastball in. But that's where I want to live with that pitch. I don't want to let Will Hoyt get those arms extended. 17 home runs on the year, but just doesn't feel like he likes that fastball in. Like a changeup. That's a weird 0-2 pitch to a right-handed hitter.
Don't get nervous, Kyle Peterson. You're on squeeze play right now.
Oh, no. No. Say kind of smart things.
Out of play. And onto the roof. Don't try to overdo it.
Okay.
Because you've been breathe. Too boxed anyway.
Just breathe. Oh, we are. All right. Then they're probably not listening to us anyway, so that's perfect.
I wouldn't either.
Nope. Oh, no. Now we're in the big box. Just one box.
Into right field, looking to tag will be the speedy Ketchup, pardon me, into center. Cannarella doesn't have a strong arm. Here comes Ketchup, the throw, all the way through, and Lipscomb has tied it on a sack fly to center field.
It's a very giving Lipscomb lineup, two sacks in a row. So the sack bunt gets the base runners over to second and third with one out. This one didn't go far, but it went just far enough. You talk about the freshman out in center field, but you got the guy standing on third base, and if you're Lipscomb, you want to take a little bit of a chance, but catch a leadoff single. Advances to second on the single, third on the sack, then scores on the sack fly, and Lipscomb has now tied this thing.
So an automatic walk to Austin Kelly with two out, and Jake Berg coming up. Must have been a pretty good timeout that Jeff Forehand took.
That's worth burning one right there.
Berg looks at a fastball for a strike. Swung at the first pitch he saw in the second inning. He's 0 for 1. Junior out of Green Bay, Wisconsin. And pulls a foul. Was a starter behind the plate at Jacksonville University. Last couple of years, transferred into Lipscomb. National Honor Society in high school at Bayport High School. Also a two-time all-conference football player. 0-2 in the dirt.
That's pretty good work by Cooper Engel, because that was about a 58-footer right there. One thing to block it, but he blocked it and kept it right in front of home plate. Nobody could advance.
Breaking ball low and in. Two on with two out to Jake Berg. Spoils another.
Yeah.
is a massive hole up the middle right now. Bertram pulled way to the pull side, but Blackwell playing almost straight up at short. Didn't matter.
The fastball up in the zone, but before that happened, a couple of singles from Ketchup and Vergara. And after a sack fly, they've tied it to two.
I'm the sizzle of this promposal.
Stacy!
And while Romeo over here is trying to look cool, things are about to heat up.
Darn it, Kyle!
And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, you can end up paying for this yourself. So get Allstate.
Kia, movement that inspires.
Wingstop has 12 flavors of chicken sandwich. In my day, we had one flavor, chicken. Now they have a garlic parmesan, a mango habanero, and a lemon pepper. Given the flavor at Wingstop.
The course, Jack, built.
Oh my goodness, go in!
Jack is the man.
Slept so mean, got big plays from your phone to the big screen. Yeah, you'll feel like a VIP. Top shelf content blowing up your feed. ESPN Plus, it's in the app. Everything you want right here, no cap.
Welcome to the NCAA Baseball Regionals presented by Capital One. Coverage for all 16 sites continues tomorrow on ESPN Plus and the ESPN app. For more information, you can visit NCAA.com, the home for all 90. NCAA championships. Doug Kinsmore Stadium here in Clemson, where Lipscomb Bisons have tied this thing up at two.
Interesting note out of Baton Rouge. Paul Skeen is going to start the opener against Tulane today.
Wow.
LSU may throw off, but they won't.
Engel singled and scored in the first for Clemson, and the first pitch from Logan Mantrique misses low. It's an LSU team that was number one in the country for 11 consecutive weeks. One of the longest runs in the long history of the Baseball America poll, and the other three that were up there all had superstars. You're talking teams like that mid-80s Oklahoma State team, Stanford team from 88. North Carolina team that ended the season in Omaha. LSU just didn't seem to be the same team at the end of the year that they were in the heart of it.
They weren't. No. I mean, two big injuries to their pitching staff. Shores and Edwards went down. That totally changed their bullpen. There's not as much depth there as there is with some other places. That's why it surprises me, honestly, even more that Skeen's in pitching today. Florida going Jack Caglione in the opener today.
To short, here's Ketchup. Caglione had been the day three starter for Florida most of the season, and we'll get to see another Olerud finalist in this game with Caden Grice, who's already homered. Well, Taylor struck out his first time up.
This is tough to pull the trigger on that one. A big old slow breaking ball at 73. The fastball's been living 91, 92.
Thank you.
He's not afraid to throw that glove side fastball, so into the right-handed hitters. He's got a lot of outs so far. Seven outs of this game, five via the strikeout so far for Van Treek.
Hit him in the foot. And that's sets it up for Caden Grice, who took one 399 his first time up.
107 off the bat. What wind there is, blowing out towards right center field. Big man got plenty of this one. Sails beyond those stands. That the only runs scored today by Clemson. Two-run home run by Grice in the first.
17th home run of the season. He has been prone to the strikeout. Third in the ACC with 70 Ks on the year. Hit him. Trying to go off speed to the lefty. And now two on with one out. Back-to-back hit batters. Came in with only one hit batter on the year. Pardon me, four hit batters on the year, like I said.
And now back-to-back, both on the breaking ball. One down and into the right-hander, and then that one just sailed right out of his hands. It is hot if you're not using that rosin bag, which you got it when it gets like this. Sometimes that ball will slip a little bit out of his hands. But for a kid that's had great control this year, he's now created traffic of his own here in the third.
Here's Billy Amick. Amick's had one of the biggest hits of the season for Clemson. Here's a look at the check swing.
Yep, just far enough. Billy McGuire, first base umpire today.
It's a real big leaguer.
Omaha Creighton Prep High School, by the way, Tom Hart.
Mm-hmm.
Former All Big Eight. Yes, All Big Eight catcher.
End up getting drafted by the Mariners. How many big leaguers do you think umpiring college baseball these days?
I think there's too many. Billy McGuire's got more big league home runs than anybody in the ballpark. Well, maybe not ballpark. Anybody on the field. I'm going to go too far with that.
Well, speed got by the catcher, Kelly, and gets all the way to the backstop. Van Treek has created his own issues in this third inning. Got to get out of it.
Yeah, uncharacteristic, and it's the misses have come with that pitch. They've all come via the breaking ball. Austin Kelly was trying to get out and almost tackle that thing, but couldn't get out quite in time. Now Clemson, two-hit batters and a wild pitch, has two in scoring position here with just one out.
12 home runs for Amick. Was mentioning that Amick's got one of the biggest hits of the season for Clemson against Georgia State back on March 10th. A game that he didn't even start. In the ninth inning, down 8-5 with two out. And a walk-off 446-foot grand slam. Got his first start the very next day. And has turned in an All-American season. And sends this line drive to right field. Will Lee coming over. Catch on the run. Tagging is Taylor, and he'll score with ease. 59 ribbies now for Amick, and Clemson back in front by one.
Doing a job right there. Van Treek did him a few favors in this inning. Three, in fact. Hit two through one to the backstop. Gets Clemson a runner in scoring position with less than two outs. And Billy Amick does his job. Didn't hammer it, but got enough of it. Will Lee over. Will Taylor in easily to give Clemson the lead back at 3-2.
And so a mound visit here in the third inning. Pitching coach Matt Myers in his second season at Lipscomb. He's pitched in this ballpark for Tennessee back in the day.
Yeah.
In a regional, as a matter of fact.
Pitched back in the R.A. Dickey days at Tennessee.
Costliest Baseball America cover in history.
Be accurate.
Mm-hmm. visit is done. And Bertram at the plate now, switch hitter. Struck out his first time up. To the fastball and a first pitch strike. And now you're getting an indication of what that meeting was about.
I think some of it may be just trust that fastball. Let's go back to it, because that's bang, bang, two at the bottom of the zone. Both caught the plate. Van Trigg, 91 and 92 in those last two pitches. Getting back to a plus count.
Bertram, shallow right field. Lee was deep, but he's able to close ground and haul it in. Couple of hit batters and a wild pitch, and Clemson reclaims the lead in the third.
Hey, and one more.
No, I think we got it.
Yeah, let's focus on the RV. Come on.
RV?
Okay, everybody, look at the RV and smile.
This is what you want for your family portrait.
Good point. We bundled the boat with our home and auto first. Hey, team, get on in here.
Team? Oh. Fun.
Now everyone say 24/7 financial protection with Progressive.
24/7 financial protection with Progressive.
Okay.
Let's get some singles and me on the bike. Honey?
Yeah.
The GMC Sierra with hands-free driving. Yeah, it rocks. Or did 0.9% APR plus over 1,200 trade assistance and no monthly payments for 90 days on Sierra 5.3-liter Ecotec 3 V8 light-duty models.
Two entrees and an appetizer for $25 now with steak. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
This is what's called a game summary. It's got a very important responsibility.
It summarizes a game. And this is what it is so far. So three innings in, Van Trigg gave up the two-run shot in the first, caused some of his own issues in the third. For Gordon, he's been good so far. Caden Grice was the one that hit the two-run shot deep into right center field over the bleachers. Clemson gets one in the third to retake the lead.
Parks back to lead off the fourth inning. He has scored one of the runs for Lipscomb when he advanced on an Austin Gordon balk after a bloop single in the second. Heads up. Ground ball to short, Blackwell. A little hop with it. One down.
Austin Gordon using that slider at some pretty good times today. Gets back just far enough out front. Pretty easy play for Blackwell right there. Have to throw it on the run, but it does look cool.
It does look really cool. Here's Coppedge. Mentioned that he started his college career at Virginia. UVA with a 12-0 lead now on Army. That game is in the sixth inning in Charlottesville. Army doesn't have a hit through six innings. Breaking ball fouled off. One ball, two strikes to Coppedge. Wright State leads Indiana State 4-2 in the fourth inning. Inside.
Wright State is one of those fours that you never want to draw because it feels like they're in the tournament every single year.
A couple of years ago, Tennessee needed a walk-off grand slam in the 1-4 game to knock them off. Coppedge with the strikeout. Drew Gilbert hit that grand slam.
Back to the breaking ball. Both outs in this inning have been that slider. So Gordon, pretty fastball heavy the first time around. Now breaking the slider out a little bit more. Now five strikeouts for Austin Gordon so far. Baseball's flying out of here all over the place.
Don't want that one. Don't want that one. How about this one? Will Lee's never seen that before. Pitcher didn't like it, and the third baseman didn't like it either. Why did Blake Wright have a ball?
I think they were throwing around a horn. So he got it back, and I don't know if he didn't like it or if Gordon didn't like it, and Gordon didn't like the other one, and then there were baseballs flying at the dugout, and that's a 1-2-3 fourth. Well done by Austin Gordon. First time he's retired. The Bison's in order. Clemson still leads it by one.
We love our new home.
Great neighborhood, big backyard.
But the lamps. At least Geico makes bundling our home and car insurance easy.
We saved a lot.
For bundling made easy, go to geico.com. The GMC Sierra with hands-free driving. Yeah, it rocks. Or did 0.9% APR plus over 1,200 trade assistance and no monthly payments for 90 days on Sierra 5.3-liter Ecotec 3 V8 light-duty models.
Foul too big.
What?
Get two entrees and an appetizer for $25 now with steak.
This is Squeeze Play, where we bring you the best moments of all around college baseball.
Here we go, Apple Taco! Three-run Johnson. Oh! Goodness gracious.
Let's get excited.
Let's get quadratic.
What more do you want? Are you not entertained?
Yeah, and by the way, nobody wants to go home. Just play it out, run it back, let's go.
The star of Squeeze Play, Michael Patrick Rooney. He'll get quadratic on you.
How about that crew? Runes, Berkey, Chris Budden, Matt Schick. Awesome way to get caught up on everything that's going on across the country. And every once in a while, you can hear us. I'm told they were taking us live.
Oh.
With their voices. Not now, but earlier, which means they probably won't do it again. But
live is always better than the alternative.
Yes.
Here's Blake Wright to lead off the fourth inning for Clemson. And he swings at the first. One down. And that'll bring Benjamin Blackwell to the plate. Blackwell started his career at Dayton. Four seasons there. First team all-conference performer with the Flyers. Now in his second season at Clemson, he was 327 hitter last year. One of three Tigers to start every game. Breaking ball in for a strike. Blackwell's comfortable in the leadoff spot and had been a regular up there both last year and his career at Dayton, but in the eight hole now. Fastball up for the strikeout.
I like that sequence. Breaking ball that comes back with two straight fastballs and into the plus count. And Trink has had pretty good success going to this spot. Elevate fastball, glove side. Blackwell swings right through it. That's now six strikeouts in the day for Logan Van Trink.
Here's Jack Crichton. First strikeout for Van Trink since the second. He's looking for a bounce back inning. Two hit batters in a wild pitch led to a run in the third from the Lipscomb ace. Van Trink is only the third Lipscomb pitcher in their Division I era with 100 strikeouts. Little dribbler. Here's Coppedge. And it's a 1-2-3 inning on only eight pitches for Logan Van Trink. We'll hear from Lipscomb head coach Jeff Forehand when we return.
Research shows people remember heartwarming ads. So to help you remember that Liberty Mutual customizes your home insurance, here's a touching moment.
I want to give you something very special that I wore on my wedding day.
Liberty Mutual customizes your home insurance so you only pay for what you need. I love you, Mom.
I love you, too.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 Liberty.
YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable. And who doesn't like more? Just ask anyone who loves basketball. And they'll tell you, there's no such thing as too much of it. Watch more games at once with MultiView on YouTube TV. YouTube TV, it's more than cable for $600 less than cable. Try it for free.
Forehand joining us on headset now. Coach, what did you tell your team about making the transition from the conference tournament now to the NCAA tournament?
You know, a lot of the same. And I think our schedule we played, you know, coming up to this point, I think prepared us for this kind of atmosphere. We played in a few venues this year just similar to this. So, you know, after dropping the first two games in a tournament, you know, and then having some resilience to come back, I feel like we were in good shape, you know, coming into this.
Hey, Jeff, Logan Van Trink, I know, did not have a great year last year, started in the bullpen, but he's been so important for you on the mound. What's the change? What's made him so good?
You know, we talked about it just the other day, and, you know, I asked him, I said, what'd you do different? Because he's a worker. He's the best kid on the team. He, you know, won our Dugan Award. I mean, he's just the best kid going. And I asked him, he said his faith just got stronger, and he just continued to work at it and continued to do the same things he did. And, you know, and it, from one year to the next, this would have been a crazy transition.
Coach, thanks for your time. We'll let you go to work. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Jeff.
Two-time ASUN Coach of the Year the last 2 years. They moved to Division I in 2001. They were an NAIA powerhouse before that with a couple of national championships in the late 70s. Caleb Ketchup leads off the fifth inning. And he puts the first ball in play. Deep center field. Cantarella back, and that one's gone! Lead-off home run for Caleb Ketchup. Seventeenth of the season, Lipscomb back on its feet, and we're tied at three.
Jeff Forehand's going to want to do an interview every half inning right now. Just got down in the third base coaching box, and how about this for your leadoff hitter? He's reached base all three times, first pitch slider, and this ball is juiced. He knew he got it about halfway up the scoreboard, and that one swing right there ties it at three here in the fifth. Lipscomb is not going anywhere.
Got something brewing here. He mentioned the venues that they've played in already this season. They took two out of three from Notre Dame. They got wins against then-ranked teams Louisville, which was 18th in the country at the time, and on the road at number six, Arkansas. They played at Auburn. They played at Mississippi State. They played against Tennessee and Vanderbilt. This has been a crazy up-and-down season for Lipscomb. And this ball's touched deep. Back-to-back jacks. Vergara sends it over the seats. And Lipscomb takes a 4-3 lead in the fifth on a 455-foot home run.
There are no doubters, and then there's those that you don't really have a lot of words for, and this would be right one of those right here. 110 off the bat, 455 feet. Vergara knew that he got all of this one the minute it came off the bat. Spun, threw his bat back, and Lipscomb has their first lead of the day.
Did this go over the roof?
This, whatever was out there, it went over. It went over cars and people, buildings, back-to-back jacks for Lipscomb, and they're up 4-3.
Mason Lundgren looks at the pitch low. One bugaboo for Austin Gordon this season. He has allowed a lot of home runs. 17 coming into this. The 1-0 is waved out. 1-1 now. It's a Lipscomb team that at one point in the season had an 11-game losing streak. After that, they won every A-Sun series. They went into the conference tournament, and they lost their first two games. But it was pool play, and they still qualified to move on, and coming out of the loser's bracket, then they won their final three, get the automatic berth in this tournament. Lundgren came out of his hat on that one. Six strikeout for Gordon.
We talked early that if Lipscomb was going to have a chance in this one, it felt like they'd have to hit it in the seats. Well, they do back-to-back times, and Lundgren trying to do it again right there. A little bit out in front on that fastball. Good bounce-back strikeout for Austin Gordon right there.
And that's going to do it probably. 6-8 pitches in for Gordon.
Nick Clayton was up and throwing in that Clemson bullpen, and the slow walk combined with the fact that it's Eric Backich, you would think that's going to be it for Austin Gordon. And it is. Call the bullpen made, and Clemson will go to the big right-hander.
Lipscomb with its first lead of the game on back-to-back home runs.
NCAA and its member schools offer nearly 500,000 college athletes a path to go pro in something other than sports. Learn more at NCAA.org.
YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable. And more is an especially good thing to have if you love basketball. We just hope you can handle this much of it. Watch more games at once with MultiView on YouTube TV. YouTube TV, it's more than cable for $600 less than cable. Try it for free.
To the best friend I could ever ask for, my ultimate ride or die. Ride or die.
People are going to start asking questions. We have to get our story straight.
Just lay low.
Everything's going to be okay.
You pushed me past my breaking point. Really, Megan?
I hate seeing you like this, but I need to know what happened.
And what if you don't like what you hear?
Cruel Summer, season premiere Monday at 9 on Freeform and stream on Hulu.
So Clemson heads to the bullpen in the fifth inning, trailing the A-Sun champs from Lipscomb 4-3. And Nick Clayton is the new pitcher on the mound for the Tigers. 6'5 right-hander out of York, South Carolina. 7-0 with a 3.18 ERA. He has struck out 49 in 45 and a third.
A little different look. So low three quarters, he's really going to work the bottom part of the zone, primarily fastball slider for Clayton this year. Walk total high. Most of the time it's because he's missing down and out of the zone. Right now for Lipscomb, you're just trying to force that ball up. Make sure you see it belt high to start, or else it's probably not going to end up in the zone.
Fourth year in the program. pitched against Miami. In the championship game, allowed three runs over two and a third. Dealing with Trace Wilhoit now. Is that a sinker?
Yep. Just a two-seamer that he's getting through over that kind of low three-quarter slot. When it's right, it goes almost straight down.
Clayton's bounced back and forth from starter to reliever over the course of the season. And that arm slot for him that you were talking about is new. And reinvented himself this past offseason. 2-2.
It was off. Was trying to backdoor the two-seamer, and it just didn't quite come back enough.
Ground ball pitcher gives up one right between the shortstop and second baseman against the ship. And a one-out single for Wilhoit.
Is that one you probably turn around on the mound? You think it's a two-hopper to the shortstop, but shortstop not playing where he usually does. That time, Blackwell pushed all the way to the pole side. Bertram was just a step or two to the shortstop side of second base. Nobody had a shot at it.
So here's Austin Kelly, who was walked intentionally with two outs in the third inning before a strikeout of Jake Berg. Sinker for a strike, nothing in one. Clemson's turned 44 double plays this season. Second most in the ACC. Nothing at two. And down goes Kelly. One down.
A changeup right there from Nick Clayton, too. So two-seamer, two-seamer. That changeup's got the exact same action as the two-seam fastball does, but about 7 or 8 mile-an-hour difference, enough to get Kelly all the way out in front.
So two down, and Berg to the plate. Fly out and a strikeout for Berg. Hit him in the foot. It's a Clemson team that has won 16 in a row. Berg was happy to take that one.
Yeah, he wasn't going anywhere.
Here's Parks Bauk. He singled and scored in the second. And ripped it foul. And a pitch low and in. And Lipscomb's already hit two home runs in this inning. And they got a chance to do more damage before it's over.
They can strike quick.
Two and one to Bauk. Not only does Lipscomb have the lead, but they've got their ace on the mound. The fifth will be a big one for him. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Chopped to third. Skipper Jeff Forehand there. They've run into some buzzsaws in the past. In 2015, lost in the first round to Vanderbilt, and first rounder Carson Fulmer. Then 1-2 at Georgia in 2008 before that. To third base. Coming in is Wright, bobbles it, and it's too late. And Lipscomb's loaded the bases here in the fifth inning.
That's the Clemson defense. It's been pretty good the entire season. They came infield 978 as a club. Blake Wright charges this one, which he has to based on where he is, but it just goes right up on the top of that glove. Then once, twice, takes him about four steps to get a handle on it. Enough time to get Bauk over it, to allow Bauk to get to first base. Now Lipscomb's got him loaded again.
This is David Coppedge. Coppedge came up with a huge hit in the second inning, driving the first run of the game for the Bisons. Nothing at two. Well, two to Coppedge into center field. Cannarella waits there. Lipscomb leaves the bases loaded, but before that, back-to-back home runs for Ketchup and Vergara. We'll talk with Clemson head man Eric Backich after this.
Around here, we like to keep things simple and honest.
Sure do. That's why at Progressive, we show you rates from other companies, even if they're lower than ours, so you can choose what's best for your family.
Comparing rates used to be a hard day's work, but not with AutoQuote Explorer.
Need me to help again?
No.
So join us and taste why Progressive is the name people trust.
Sorry, are we talking about apples now or insurance? Why is that funny?
Now that you've moved back home,
I have a resume here.
Your mom has made it her job to find you a job. Any job.
Resume. I'm gonna give you his resume.
You need something more related to your skills and interests.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do.
When your resume is on Indeed, you get matched with relevant jobs that fit your requirements.
Where do you get your persistence from?
So everyone else can go back to minding their own business.
Tom Hart, Kyle Peterson, happy to be joined by Clemson head coach Eric Backich. Coach, you've been part of some incredible postseason runs. In your mind, how do you balance a sense of urgency with keeping your team relaxed in moments like this?
Well, that's just it. I mean, we've played so many of these types of games. The periphery around the white lines might be different. There's more people here and it's louder, but between the white lines, we are very comfortable with this type of a game, and we've been here so many times. We'll have to just respond like we've done all year. But this is a very good team. Lipscomb is an excellent, athletic, balanced team, and the pitcher, Van Treek, on the mound has got really good command of two different breaking balls. So he's been giving us some trouble. We'll have to do a better job third time through the order.
How do you get him? I mean, offensively, is there anything that you've told your guys specifically about going after him the rest of the way?
Yeah, I mean, he's one of those guys that he's just got enough deception with a little bit of a funky delivery, but it's the induced vertical break on the fastball that you have to push the fastball down, and then you have to see the off-speed up. I mean, it's really just got to make him a two-pitch guy and, you know, just try it. Cam struggled with the slider so far today, and, you know, he's just got to do a good job of seeing that pitch up. And with all these guys, just stay on the fastball. Hit the fastball in the oppo gap, and then if they get a hanging breaking ball, try to pull it.
Eric, thanks for your time. We appreciate it.
All right, guys. Hey, thank you.
Thank you.
Cam Cannarella with a pair of strikeouts, as Backich mentioned, struggling with the slider. Van Treek has struck out six. He only needed eight pitches to get through the bottom of the order in the fourth, and here he is starting his third trip through the lineup. 2-1. That might be the one Cannarella wanted if he's been struggling with the slider.
Yeah.
One,
you get back-to-back fastballs and the slider's giving him fits. He got into a plus count, but then couldn't pull the trigger on two fastballs. Bottom part of the zone right there. Now, Van Treek has worked the count back 2-2.
Any way you can translate what Backich was saying about how to approach Van Treek?
I mean, I think it helps now that they've seen him twice. The biggest thing is just making sure you're picking the ball up out of his hand. That the front side is deceptive enough, and Erica was talking about it. He goes high with that glove side. You got to make sure you're trying to pick it up as quickly as you can out of the hand. That was a good take.
Treek is 6'4", 206 pounds. And does a good job of hiding it. Here the 3-2 now to Cannarella, ACC Freshman of the Year. Breaking ball hammered up the middle and a leadoff single. Cannarella's got to feel great about that, A.B.
Eric Backich just said, try to see the breaking ball up, and that's exactly what he got right there. Cannarella, who had struggled with the slider the first two times up, worked it to a three-ball count, first three-ball count of the day for Logan Van Treek. Left a slider up. Cannarella fires it to center, and the leadoff man standing on first base for Clemson.
And now Cooper Engel, who's 1-for-2. First pitch fastball. Van Treek's favorite movie is Groundhog Day, and he's not afraid to repeat pitches, is he? Especially that fastball.
This may be his favorite song, too. Did you see that? He started dancing right when it came on. I'd say he's loose. See the wipe right there. So Van Treek gets the sign, and then he was probably wiping to something else.
Chopped up the middle. Ketchup can't get it. We tried to apply the tag at the same time he fielded it. And Clemson's got two on with nobody out.
That's just good baseball luck right there for Clemson and bad baseball luck for Lipscomb, because in some cases this is potentially going to be a double play. Ball located well, but defensively, the way that Lipscomb was playing, I thought maybe that hit the runner, but it didn't. It hit the glove. All in one motion. Ketchup there, you probably want to try to get that out at first base. So much it's got to go right to glove it, make the tag.
And so Tigers have two on with nobody out, and Will Taylor up. Ruled an error, 17th of the season, charged Ketchup. Taylor was hit by a pitch last time up. And drops the bunt down the third baseline, foul.
Clemson 19 sack bunts on the year. Will Taylor has just one.
That one will be picked up late, and barehand late. Will Hoyt was in no man's land, thought about letting that thing roll, but it wasn't going to approach the chalk, and Clemson's loaded the bases.
You got to commit to one on this. You either commit to charging it as hard as you can to make it a play, or you commit to letting it roll, and in that case, roll the dice. I think he was waiting to see what it was going to do when it got off the cut of the grass, and it stayed pretty true after that. Not enough time for Will Hoyt. Now back to back to back base runners here for Clemson. That'll get Matt Myers back out of the Lipscomb dugout.
Only 76 pitches into this for Vantreek. They will get action in the bullpen. Ethan Smith, a big game experience. I would think they're going to give Vantreek every opportunity to get out of this.
Yeah, I would think they are too. I mean, the stuff hasn't ticked down. His fastball is exactly where it was to start this game. He hadn't had the best pitching luck in this inning. He got a ground ball in the infield that you don't get an out of, and then a bunt that is intended to be a sack that goes as a single.
So here's Caden Grice. He can do some damage and a big cut. On the first pitch, our first final of the NCAA tournament is in. Kentucky shut out Ball State 4-0. Game one in Lexington. Grice with a 399-foot home run in the first. And he lifts it to left. Ranging is Berg. Campanella's got good speed, tagging from third. The throw is a little bit high to the cutoff man. But a sack fly from Caden Grice drives another one home, and we're tied at four. And now Billy Amick coming up. I know pitchers don't want to give up any runs, but
you'll take that
Caden Grice out with the bases loaded.
You'll take that trade. I think both sides will take that trade. For Clemson, let's just push one across and tie this thing. And for Lipscomb, if we can get it out and only give up one, now you're a hard ground ball away from getting out of this thing.
Amick had a sack fly in the third. He's 0 for 1 with a strikeout. That's blocked by Austin Kelly. Engel the runner at second. Taylor's at first. Slider hammer deep left field. Berg is back and he's got space. Two down. And Vantreek just an out away from escaping this jam. Burton with a strikeout and a pop-up today. And he sends a line drive into center field. Vergara on the run, won't get there. Hops off the top of the fence, one run in. Here comes the second. Ketchup's relay is just a hair late. And Clemson gets two home on a double from Riley Bertram.
Grad transfer from Michigan and knows his way around the postseason. Comes up big right there. Bertram hunting first pitch fastball. got it and hammered it out of left center field. They were pushed a little bit opposite in center field. One hops the fence. It's not a comfortable slide right there. Will Taylor comes in. That's now three in the frame for Clemson, and they take the lead right back.
He's taking harder hits on a gridiron. Couple of ribbies for Bertram. Here's Blake Wright. The 1-0. Into right, this is Will Lee. And Clemson with a huge bounce back fifth inning, a three spot to answer the two home runs from Lipscomb. And it's a 6-4 lead for the Tigers.
I'm your overly competitive brother.
Check.
Psych. And I'm about to steal this game from you, just like I stole Kelly Carter in high school, huh?
You got no game. Dude, that's a foul.
And now you're ready to settle a score. Game over. And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, well, you can end up paying for all this yourself. So get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem. Yeah, like me.
Thanks, bro.
Take a lap, rookie.
Real mature.
That's a pretty tight spot.
Watch this.
Your Buick parks itself. That's so you.
Of course you know where we're going. That's so you.
Kind of got a sixth sense.
And a head-up display.
They're here.
At the heart of every Buick SUV is you.
Get 2.49% APR and no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get $750 purchase allowance on 2023 Buick Encore GX models.
The Doritos Cool Ranch Papadilla. It's the best idea ever.
Whoa, 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 whoa. The Doritos Cool Ranch Papadilla was my idea. My idea. I invented that on a jet ski. Instead of doing donuts on the water like the mother guys, I do triangles. Like Doritos chips and pizza. Then it hit me. Doritos and Papa John's. You're welcome, world. Another one.
The Doritos Cool Ranch Papadilla.
I did that. Yeah. Genius.
Well, Lipscomb in the top of the fifth inning hit a couple of home runs. One from Alex Vergara ended up on the Bart, Rick Irwin's. And then Clemson answered with a three-run bottom half of the inning. And we've got a 6-4 game. What do you want off the grill today? You want sausage? You want a burger? Maybe some other assorted meats?
What do we got? We got the Cajun Cafe out, right? We probably got to have something Cajun. A little.
Yeah, I would think so.
Firing up out there today.
The smoker was going early.
We got enough time in between games. We have to take a little walk. Meet some new friends.
Nick Clayton is the second pitcher of the game for Clemson. He entered in the fifth inning following those two home runs. At CajunRF is the Twitter. Hey, they're talking about you guys on TV. You might want to send a couple of plates up between games. Adjacent to the cheap seats. Anytime a bus is the basis for your outfield seats, you're doing something weird, and I like it. This is Will Lee, the right fielder, who's 0 for 2. Army finally found a hit, but Virginia leads 14-1 in the bottom of the eighth inning. And a good one brewing in Gainesville. They've gone to the bottom of the ninth. Texas Tech leads UConn by one. Little duck snort will land foul.
Where in the world did duck snort come from? I mean, it feels to fit perfectly, but I don't know. I have to know the history of that. I expected you would just know the answer. Do ducks snort? Well, that's what I was wondering. I don't even know if it's possible.
Duck snort originally had a different word on the back end.
Yes, it
flatulence.
Did.
Flatulence.
That's fair.
So that would be soft as a duck snort, I guess.
Now snorting, yeah.
Getting into baseball etymology. Lee goes down swinging. Second K for Clayton.
He's looked good since trotting out of that bullpen. This was the changeup. Ended up probably a good 8 to 10 inches off the plate, but it has such good sink and such good arm side run. Lee couldn't hold up. Caleb Ketchup, they'll turn the lineup over, who's already had a pretty productive day.
Yeah, I'd say, what if I told you that Hawk Harrelson popularized duck snort?
That would make total sense then.
Swing and a miss for Ketchup. That was quick. Back-to-back K's now for Clayton.
That's efficient. Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Got to 0-2 on the sinker. Looks like a slider right there. That doesn't have a whole lot of right to left, but has enough to get Ketchup all the way out in front. Two straight strikeouts to start the sixth here for Nick Clayton.
I'm still not sure where Vergara's ball landed.
If the reaction of the people that were sitting in the very last row is indicative, it went way over their heads.
There's a little kid at the top of the grandstand that was peering over the fence with his back to home plate. As a pitcher, would you appreciate having TrackMan when you're on the mound?
For
scenarios
my stats,
like that?
Yeah. I don't necessarily want to see how far Troy Gloss hit a ball off me, no.
Two hits for Vergara. And now that's in for a strike, 2-1.
It went over that. That's a roof. Still only counted for one, though.
And he touches this one deep to left field, and he's got a pair. Home runs 22 and 23 on the season for Vergara. And we got a one-run game again.
Knew right away when he got this one, too. Bat flip wasn't quite as good. Bat flip the first time was kind of like a bat javelin. This one he put down a little bit more, but that's now three home runs on the day for Lipscomb and two off of this bat right here. Nice, easy swing. 378 feet out to left center field, 108 off the bat.
First one was a javelin. Second one was more like a lawn dart.
They don't make those anymore.
More dangerous. Lawn darts became outlawed about the same time that seatbelts became required. Tell you something. You ever sit in the third row of a station wagon facing backwards with no seatbelt on?
Not quite that old. Close. I mean, I would have, but no.
Lundgren punched out, but Alex Vergara with a couple of home runs. His second goes 378 off the bat. That was a big hit. We'll show you a strikeout.
I'm the sizzle of this promposal.
Stacy!
And while Romeo over here is trying to look cool, things are about to heat up.
Darn it, Kyle!
And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, you can end up paying for this yourself. So get Allstate.
That's a pretty tight spot.
Watch this.
Your Buick parks itself. That's so you.
Of course you know where we're going. That's so you.
I got a sixth sense.
And a head-up display.
They're here.
At the heart of every Buick SUV is you.
Get 2.49% APR and no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get $750 purchase allowance on 2023 Buick Encore GX models.
Discover the precision and power of a DR trimmer mower. Trim precisely without arm fatigue. Mow where a bladed mower can. The DR has up to 5 times the power of a handheld trimmer, and our durable heavy-duty cord is ideal for the toughest mowing tasks.
Go online to drtrimmer.com to request your free product catalog. DR trimmer mowers are now on sale, and free shipping is in effect. Hurry, this offer won't last. That's drtrimmer.com.
These definitely need a minute to cool down.
No, they don't. They're perfect.
We're still hot.
Try new Kentucky Fried Chicken Nuggets. You've never had nuggets like these. That's finger-licking good.
I think the Autumn Kings have it right. That home run was up above the clouds. Vergara hit. He's got 3 hits, including a couple of home runs in this one. Can we do the game out there like that?
We can try. It's worth trying.
Anything's worth trying.
Well, most.
It'd be tough to see. 8-hole hitter Benjamin Blackwell. Angel Campos, home plate umpire, giving the edges. Ouch, nothing in two. To push that shin guard down just a little bit.
I think it got a piece of it, but not all of it.
So the wristband that Clemson wears around its belt buckle is a staple of Eric Backich coach teams. When he was at Michigan, he would instill phrases that had nothing to do with baseball on that wristband. Send him a code, and might be one that just said, have fun, relax, smile. Would that work for you as a player?
Would I want to see that?
Yeah.
Probably would have been good.
Tipped into the catcher's mitt for strike three. Number 7 for Van Treek.
You can see the different approach on both of these sides. I mean, Logan Van Treek has been their guy all year. And it's not like he's getting hammered all around the ballpark, but still, he's 87, 88 pitches, giving up 6 runs. But yet back out there for the sixth. They're going to run with him as far as they possibly can. Fastball still holding velo. I mean, he was 90 to 92 in the first, that last one at 91.
Here's Jack Crichton. And I think it's pretty simple, right? I mean, this is their best pitcher and gives them the best chance to win. And he's shown that he can go deep into games. Snared over at first by Lundgren. That'll help.
Yeah, but he gets a quick one here. He probably goes out for the seventh. Lundgren wasn't going to move too far on that. He was kind of spread out, just hitting the right spot. Could drop that mitt down there and grab it. Two quick outs here. Clemson will turn the lineup over. Camarillo, the freshman, struck out his first two times up, then lined a slider to center in the fifth. Came around to score.
First pitch breaking ball. By the way, the hardest working person in the ballpark is the woman right behind home plate.
With the balloon?
With the balloon.
Yes.
She's like the St. Joseph's Hawk mascot. She never stops. 2-0. I mean, I realize balloons aren't heavy.
Locked in, too. And there's a little bit of a pause right after the pitch. And then her internal clock, it's like great shortstops. They have really good internal clocks. She does, too. She knows right about the time to start the balloon action back up. The guy next to her seems totally oblivious to it. He's getting popped on top of the head. Balloon right in his line of sight sometimes. He's rolling with it.
They handed out dozens of those balloons before the game. She's really the only active balloon waiver. Leo's following suit. That'll keep you cool. To the backstop on ball four to Cam Cannarella. And that is the first walk of the game from Logan Van Treek, go against seven strikeouts.
It's only a 2-3 ball count. I mean, that's why he's been able to keep the pitch count pretty efficient, given six runs on seven hits and the amount of base runners that Clemson's had.
Visit from Austin Kelly. Action continues for the Bisons and Ethan Smith. Cooper Engels singled and scored in the first, and he looks at a first pitch fastball up, maybe a little bit out, 1-0. Next pitch will be Van Treek's 100th. Didn't go. 2-1.
Just missing with that fastball up. It's been close right there.
Seven times. In nine starts, Van Treek's gone over 100 pitches, and this ball well hit to left center. Vergara on the run and makes the catch up onto the ramp. No runs, no hits, but a walk and one left. We're six into it, and Clemson leads by one.
massage the very little foil, basting every 20 minutes to keep it from drying out. And voila.
This is gonna taste all right.
I'm your overly competitive brother.
Check.
Psych. And I'm about to steal this game from you, just like I stole Kelly Carter in high school, huh?
You got no game. Dude, that's a foul.
And now you're ready to settle a score. Game over. And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, well, you can end up paying for all this yourself. So get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem. Yeah, like me.
Thanks, bro.
Take a lap, rookie.
Real mature.
Four seed Clemson holding on to a one-run lead on Lipscomb as we go to the seventh. Van Treek has struck out seven, walked one over six innings. Alex Vergara has got a couple of home runs. And Caden Grice with a two-run home run early. Riley Bertram with a two-run double late. And that's where we stand. Wilhoit, Kelly, and Berg do up for Lipscomb here in the seventh.
It is great to see this place packed. See postseason baseball. Back at Clemson, 1 o'clock start time, and it was standing room only.
Hosting for the first time since 2018. Will Hoyt drove in a run with the sack fly. Forty-fifth regional for Clemson. Ninth most ever. One and two. '18 Clemson lost to Vandy here at home. 2017 Vandy also came and went with it. 2016 lost to Oklahoma State. '11 UConn advanced after out of the Clemson region. Golf to center. Here's Cannarella. One down. Go back to 2002, the team that ended up in Omaha before losing to South Carolina. How about this coaching staff? Kevin O'Sullivan's at Florida. Jack Leggett's got his number retired here. Package back in the upstate. Tim Corbin's pretty good, too.
Sullivan, Backage, Corbin. All three of them top eight national seeds this year. There's Jack. Good to see him again. Took a recruiting trip here about 30 years ago, right when Jack got the job. In fact, it was just when he was named head coach.
Had he invited you or you just showed up?
No, I just showed up. Okay. Heard he was going to get the job, wanted to introduce myself.
You were just in the neighborhood, huh? Austin Kelly 0 for 2. Eric Backage certainly appreciates having him around. Backage used a phrase, it was interesting and accurate. He said, you know, when Jack's around, you see more teeth.
Yeah.
Meaning everybody's got a smile on their face. Three balls and a strike now to Austin Kelly. Second on the team in ribbies. And chase that one low.
Wow. And they're trying to give you one there. The 3-1 changeup that Kelly was dialed in looking for a fastball he could drive. Instead of standing at first base, he's got to go back to work 3-2.
And a sinker pulled foul.
Oh, no good can come out of trying to make that play. No good. Effort, yes. Hostile road environment. If you bobble it at all, you're going to hear about it.
And Todd Yost is hearing about it. Payoff again. In a one-out walk. Washington Huskies lead Dallas Baptist 8-5 in the eighth inning. Looking for an upset in the 2-3 game. And they've gone to the bottom of the eighth. At Indiana State, Wright State leads 5-3. Nothing and one to Berg.
Clayton's getting a little bit more off the plate right now. That sinker that was called a strike was probably 5-6 inches off the plate. So then it forces Berg to kind of expand his zone that way. There's room. If you can locate in right now, there's room. But you better not miss off the plate or you're going to hit him.
They hit him with two outs in the fifth. You notice what's missing when Lipscomb's at the plate? No balloon.
No. She's trying to distract the pitcher. So hold on. Sounds like everybody behind basketball going when a guy's shooting a free throw going nuts. That's her contribution today.
Thought it was just a general appreciation for being at the ballpark.
Doesn't appear that way. Resting.
Clemson leads by one. Here's the 2-2 from Nick Clayton. Soft line drive to right field. Lipscomb's got two on.
It's so much more comfortable for a left-hander than a right-hander to face a guy that has the stuff of Clayton. And this time, Berg just takes it deep into the count, gets one that's at least elevated enough that he can pull it out to right field. Lipscomb in action again today. They've only been sent down 1-2-3 one time today by this Clemson staff.
So here's Parks Bauk. And here's Eric Backich. Clayton at the 51 pitch mark, and they're going back to the bullpen. They'll do it with a right-hander coming up. And Clemson will go to Reed Garris, another right-hander, out of their bullpen.
I'm the sizzle of this promposal. And while Romeo over here is trying to look cool, things are about to heat up.
Darn it, Kyle!
And if you don't have the right home insurance coverage, you can end up paying for this yourself. So get Allstate.
That's a pretty tight spot.
Watch this.
Your Buick parks itself. That's so you.
Of course you know where we're going. That's so you.
Kind of got a sixth sense.
And a head-up display.
They're here.
At the heart of every Buick SUV is you.
Get 2.49% APR and no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get $750 purchase allowance on 2023 Buick Encore GX models.
It's pretty simple. I kind of just want things the way I want them.
I want a network that won't let me down, even up here.
With an unlimited plan that's truly right for me.
With Verizon's new My Plan, I get exactly what I want and only pay for what I need.
Now I'm in charge of my plan.
Introducing My Plan from Verizon, the first and only plan where you choose what goes in, from Apple Music to Disney Bundle, so you get exactly what you want and only pay for what you need. And it all starts at just $30 on the network you want, because it's your Verizon.
Wingstop has 12 flavors of chicken sandwich. In my day, we had one flavor, chicken. Now they have garlic parmesan, mango habanero, and lemon pepper. Given the flavor at Wingstop.
Fifty-one pitches for Nick Clayton, and his day is done. Currently pitcher of record for Clemson. He hands off to sophomore right-hander Reed Garris from down in Mount Pleasant, South Carolina. He's 4-0 with a 2.25 ERA, 36 strikeouts in 28 innings.
Very fastball heavy. It's over 80% of the time you'll see the fastball from Garris. Low 90s. To try to live at the top of the zone. When it gets into a plus count, that's when he will go to the slider some, but it's a lot of fastballs.
So he's got Bauk at the plate with the wind blowing out to right field. Bauk has one hit so far. Reached on an error last time up. And the first pitch has popped up. Grice looks all the way to the dugout, to the railing, and he got it. Oh, he had it. Oh, man.
Trying to look for everything at once, and there's a hole in that railing, too, right where it went. They're in plenty of time, just couldn't quite glove it. Now new life at the plate.
Opportunity continues for Lipscomb. Two on, one out. Here's the 0-1.
For Lipscomb, I think the approach, especially early in the count, is pretty simple. You got to force the fastball into the zone. He's going to try to get you to go for that fastball. It's just up and out of the zone. Watch the target Cooper Engel gives every time. Especially early, that target's just going to go up and up and up as he gets up in the count.
Yeah. Missed his spot, but got a strikeout. How about that? Two down.
Wasn't really trying to go there, but it worked out good. You can see that glove is set up and out of the zone. That caught the bottom part of the plate on the outside black. Unintentional, but it worked out well. First out's a strikeout for Reed Garris.
And now David Coppedge. Four home runs in the season for Coppedge, most recently in a final regular season game at Jacksonville State on May 20th. Ball fouled off again. Where is it? It always ends up like three rows lower than where people are looking.
Still nothing.
1-2 from Garris. Brooks hitting mid-90s with the fastball. In Fayetteville, Arkansas, Santa Clara has jumped out on three-seed Arkansas 2-0 in the first inning. One, two again. Just off the plate.
That missed. He feels otherwise, but he's wrong. Not where you want to throw it, though. If he goes after it, great. Still sits at a 2-2 count.
Coppedge hanging in there. Chase that one. Back-to-back strikeouts for Garris with two on and nobody out, and Lipscomb strands a pair in the seventh.
Discover the precision and power of a DR trimmer mower. Trim precisely without arm fatigue. Mow where a bladed mower can. The DR has up to 5 times the power of a handheld trimmer, and our durable heavy-duty cord is ideal for the toughest mowing tasks.
Go online to drtrimmer.com to request your free product catalog. DR Trimmer mowers are now on sale and free shipping is in effect. Hurry, this offer won't last. That's drtrimmer.com.
With the Venture X card from Capital One, you earn 2x miles on every purchase.
The noise canceling. You're being too loud.
Good choice. Ooh, my lucky number.
Plus, earn 5x miles on flights and 10x miles on hotels through Capital One Travel. What's in your wallet?
Kellogg's Rice Krispies Treats. Connect on a sweeter level.
That's a pretty tight spot.
Watch this.
Your Buick parks itself. That's so you.
Of course you know where we're going. That's so you.
I got a 6 amps.
And a head-up display.
They're here.
At the heart of every Buick SUV is you.
Get 2.49% APR and no monthly payments for 90 days. Plus, current eligible non-GM owners get $750 purchase allowance on 2023 Buick Encore GX models.
We got Will Taylor set to lead off the seventh inning. This guy knows how to get it done. A couple of ACC championships over the Blue Monster in Durham. Got my worst haircut ever in the building behind left field. And open the season against Georgia Tech in the Chick-fil-A kickoff. Home run, touchdown.
That's a decent sophomore year.
Not bad. This guy was a top prospect, quarterback in high school, top prospect in baseball. Turned down a lot of money to come to campus. And try to take advantage of both situations. Interesting watching the way Eric Backich runs his program. Very similar to what Dabo does on the football side. Ethan Smith, been in the SEC prior. 2-1 with an ERA over 6 replaces Logan Van Treek. Let's talk about Van Treek for a second. Pretty good outing for the Lipscomb ace, even though they scored 6 runs against him.
Yeah, I mean, he gave him a chance against a team that comes in here as hot as anybody in the country, and they still have a chance. Just a 1-run game here to the bottom of the seventh, but totally agree. For Van Treek, I think everything he could have asked coming into this building, obviously a spot that Lipscomb hasn't been in a whole lot in the history of their program, and a spot that Van Treek had never been in.
Smith started his college career at Tennessee. Started at Vandy and then transferred to Tennessee. And a 94-mile-an-hour fastball. Started the first 4 games of the season for Lipscomb, but he just wasn't working as a starter, and that included a 7-run outing and just an inning of 2/3 at Auburn. Nothing at 2. But 3 years at Vanderbilt and a perfect game All-American. One, two, three to take care of Taylor.
at the old number one working so far. 94-95. Coming out of the bullpen, gets in a plus count, just does exactly what Reed Garris was trying to do in the last inning. He's had fastball at the top of the zone. It's where he gets a lot of swing and miss with that pitch.
Pretty good 1-2 punch for Lipscomb to roll out Van Treek, followed by Smith. And Grice sends a fastball through the right side. One out single. Now he's stretching it and headed to second, and the throw is wide of the bag. And Caden Grice just stole an extra 90 with a hustle out of the box.
Impressive right there for Grice, and that is all his own decision. He can see it right out of the box. You can see the route that Will Lee is taking out in right field. But first pitch fastball, hunting one, got one. Lee plays it way deep, and I think that one maybe surprised him. I don't think he thought Grice was going to second. Throw was off. Clemson's got one in scoring position with one out.
Billy Amick's looking for his first hit of the game. First pitch breaking ball, nothing and one. Smith has pitched in games like this before his freshman year at Vandy. Struck out five against Duke in the Super Regional as Vandy ended its season in Omaha. Same Super Regional, Kumar Rocker had a no-hitter.
Punched out 19.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
And he's had success in this state against South Carolina down at Founders Park. Struck out 8 3 1/3 as a freshman. How about the state of South Carolina? Three regional hosts for the first time ever. Upstate, mid-state, and the low country here. Columbia and Gary Gilmore's team hosting out of Coastal Carolina. Runner on the move. Grice will take third. Got a huge jump. And his hustle has picked up an extra 90 twice.
Didn't take him too many steps.
No.
Good secondary right there, too. Started early. That secondary, you don't turn around and stop him. That time, Grice was going all the way to third base. Now it forces Lipscomb to bring the infield in right here.
Infield in with one out. Fastball up. And there's ball four. And it brings Riley Bertram to the plate. Bertram has maybe the biggest hit of the game for Clemson with the two-run double back in the fifth. Backish is going to bring everybody together over in front of the Clemson dugout. Talk about this. He's not afraid to get creative. Had a double squeeze against Florida State after the hidden ball trick.
He's run it a few times this year. For Bertram, three sack bunts. So, I mean, you could see a safety here. And depending on what this infield defense shows you, no, Amick doesn't run great. Could see action there, too.
Fake run from first. The bunt is down the line, picked up in fair territory, and that'll get a run home. Lundgren thought that one was staying fair. What did it look like to you?
It looked like it was going to stay fair. That's now two of those balls that Lipscomb has had today that are hugging the line, and this is kind of one thing you can learn the day before as to how does it play down that first base line. I think that was going to stay fair. I think it's a right move. Don't have enough time to get Grice at home plate. Again, that steal of third changes entire inning. Infield has to come in, the walk, then you can put the safety on to push another one across.
Here's Blake Wright. Ooh, foul tip on hit Kelly in his bare hand.
Yep.
Smith wants a new sign. The 0-2. Right, fouls it back.
Talk about not all four seeds created equal, and you're seeing that today for Lipscomb. They've gone A-Sun pitcher of the year and then rolled a guy out there going 94 to 96. I mean, this is like playing on a Friday night at the ACC right now.
Right, three flyouts in this one. Amick is the runner at second with two down. Chase it in the dirt, and Kelly will throw down to finish it off. The bunt that stayed fair has burned Lipscomb twice in this one. And Clemson adds an insurance run in the seventh.
Oh, well, this is me.
It's still early. You want to maybe grab a coffee?
With the Wells Fargo Active Cash Card, you earn 2% cash back on what you want, like coffee, ping pong, a movie, karaoke, and 2% cash back on what you need.
No. Just my shoe.
Like maybe shoes without laces.
Just my shoe, folks.
The Wells Fargo Active Cash Card. That's real life ready.
The Bosch 2-in-1 quickly changes between impact wrench and impact driver, so you can work fast when you're slammed. Bosch Tools, what hard workers deserve. Learn more at BoschTools.com.
Good morning. I'm Peter Davidson. Not Pete, because before 11 a.m., I like to keep it toned down and simple, just like Taco Bell breakfast, with fluffy eggs, sausage, melty cheese, and a crispy hash brown and a grilled tortilla. It's how everyone should wake up, and that's why you can all have a free breakfast Crunchwrap. You can have a Crunchwrap.
Offer valid every Tuesday in June.
Giving out free Crunchwraps.
Must be a loyalty member and order on the app.
You can have a Crunchwrap.
He just shows up and does this.
Free Crunchwraps.
To shave or not to shave?
Shave. It's true.
To shave or not to shave? That.
NCAA Regionals coverage for all 16 sites continues tomorrow on ESPN Plus and the ESPN app. For more information, visit NCAA.com, the home for all 90 NCAA championships. When do we get meat judging as an NCAA approved event?
What was the question?
Meat judging. Yeah, we need that sanctioned. I think Texas A&M is the defending champs.
Cajun Cafe's got something to say about that.
Will Lee 0 for 3. Fly ball to left field. Chasing is Taylor into the gap, and he makes a running catch. As an athlete, one down. Got a nice ovation from the folks in the grandstand out there. Here's Caleb Ketchup. One of a handful of SEC transfers on this Bison's roster. Atlanta native started his career at Georgia. And the fastball from Garris is just off, 1-0. Didn't go, 2-0.
Absolutely held up there.
Paul Skeens on the mound for LSU. The Tigers lead Green Wave of Tulane 3-0. Second inning at Alec Box Stadium. Four-pitch walk puts Ketchup on. He's reached via error, single, home run. And now the first base runner to reach against Reed Garris.
Now you get this, Cap. Hit one 455 feet and then just snuck one out at 388 the next time. Vergara's already gone deep today, both to left field.
Engel's going to go all the way to the mound, and they're going to have a meeting here. This is a Lipscomb team which set a school record of 106 home runs, and they smashed the previous record, which was 66. Alex Vergara in the fifth inning with a monster home run, and then a sixth inning with another. That's a bat flip.
that is people turning around in the top row of the stadium to see where the ball was going to land. Next one doesn't go quite as far, but it counts for just as much. Two solo jacks today, home runs number 22 and 23 on the year for Vergara. That looks like that will do it for Reed Garris. The slow walk out by Cooper Engel, and now the slow walk out by Eric Backage. Both have perfected the slow walk, by the way, because those were executed perfectly, and it looks like Clemson will go back to the bullpen.
Ryan Ammons has been throwing. They must have both been watching some Wayne Graham film. And there's the call to the bullpen. They'll allow Angel Campos, the home plate umpire, to make it. We'll break it down and tell you what to expect from Ammons right after this.
Can help you.
Maybe.
I need a pair for a wedding, one for running, one for glamping, one for brunching, boating and tanning, and then one pair for my brother that I can steal later.
Yeah, let me show you some
I'd like to look at Dolce & Gabbana, Versace, Burberry, Ray-Ban, Purcell, Oakley, Costa, Michael Kors, Coach, and Ralph Lauren.
Regular or polarized?
Sunglass Hut. Find every shade of you.
Hey, Jake from State Park.
You know, it's really scary.
Popcorn with no butter.
No, getting insurance. I mean, what if the jargon makes me feel alone and in the dark?
Hey, at State Farm, we're there for your what ifs. Ah!
Sorry. Is that seat taken?
Get on up here, buddy. Let's go. Let's go.
Most wanted?
Yeah, for my cup of ale.
I saw.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
Well, that'll do it for Reed Garris. He puts in an inning of work, but with a walk preceding Alex Vergara's trip to the plate. They'll hand it over to Ryan Ammons, Jr. from down the road in Easley. 6 foot lefties, 2-0 with a 3.72 ERA. He has struck out 26 and 19 in the third.
Two different approaches, whether he's facing righties or lefties. He's fastball heavy to either, but against righties, which he'll face first in Vergara. Primarily fastballs and then the changeup. The changeup this year hadn't thrown a ton of them, but the swing and miss percentage on the changeup against right-handers is 78%. If you're Vergara, you got to think you're going to get one. Aside from that, he's been real fastball heavy.
Vergara represents a tying run. He's homered twice. Wind blowing out to right. And first pitch fastball at 90s in for a strike. Smallish dimensions at this ballpark, made even smaller thanks to Mother Nature. We're going to see the ball fly with warm temperatures and winds throughout the weekend. Nothing in two.
Vergara got two fastballs, and the second one was about center cut. Didn't offer it either, down an 0-2 count.
They'll reset the pitch clock. There is no visible pitch clock here at Doug Kinsmore Stadium. It's kept by the third base umpire. And this one's popped up. Bertram in shallow right. Crichton coming in behind him. And Crichton calls him off and he hits the ground. Lipscomb still in business with two aboard out of miscommunication in shallow right field.
Oh, that's just overthinking that one, because for Crichton, he ends up on a dead sprint. Riley Bertram is underneath this one. He's there in plenty of time, and now Crichton in, then overruns it. And what looked to be an easy second out of the inning instead falls in right field. Lipscomb in business right here. Two on, trailing by two.
Mason Lundgren, the three-hole hitter. Everybody was on the move, and it's fouled off.
Oh, and Ketchup had it stolen. Ketchup had third base stolen right there. He had the same type of walking lead that Grice had in the last inning. You take that one, you probably got guys at second and third.
Not going here. And it's up 1-1. Ketchup's got 30 of them on the season. Two-one, they charge him with the ball thrown to an unoccupied base as the shortstop Bucknell was a little bit late to get there in a hesitation. And Eric Backich is looking for an explanation here.
I think it was the hesitation that caused most of that ultimately caused it.
This is a rule that kind of got shifted during the course of the season. It wasn't getting called a lot through the first couple of months, and about midway through major conference play, it started to become a point of emphasis, which is always tough during the course of a season. It has to be an immediate throw to an occupied base.
Now watch the pause. I mean, it's the lift and then, oh yeah, I gotta throw it.
And so it turns it into a hitter's count here for Lundgren. It could be a big mistake. To one from Ammons, runners going. The throw to third is wide, and Ketchup picks it up with Vergara filling in behind him.
Not taking that chance. First pitch of the at-bat, Ketchup had it stolen. Actually had a better jump than he did right here, and Vergara's just playing follow the leader. Ketchup gets the jump, throws a little bit high. He's in safely. 31st stolen base of the year for Caleb Ketchup. 16th for Vergara.
Lundgren with a line drive to Burcham to second and nearly got him. That's a big second out with a runner at third.
That's why you don't bring the infield in when you're ahead, because this would have been two runs, but instead it's right at Burcham, who's playing normal depth out at second base. But you're not done yet. Trace Wilhoit coming to the plate with 17 home runs on the year.
Wilhoit just got a scouting report from Lundgren and a first pitch strike at the knees. One ball, one strike. Hello, Squeeze Play, and welcome to Clemson, where Lipscomb is putting a scare into the Tigers, and the pitch is up and away. With one out, Caleb Ketchup was walked, and then Alex Vergara sent a fly ball into right field that was misplayed by Jack Crichton and Riley Burcham, and after a double steal and a line out, Lipscomb's trying to come up with a big hit, and that one is hooked foul. That would have been it.
Double steal in the eighth, down two. Got him into this spot. 2-2 count. We haven't seen Ammons throw that changeup very much. He's had really good success with it this year. Might be a good spot for him.
They're on their feet here at Doug Kingsmore Stadium. Been a back and forth affair. To short. And that'll end the inning and end the Lipscomb threat. Benjamin Blackwell took care of business, backing up Ammons, and the Bison strand a pair.
I sold my car to Carvana, and it was awesome.
I heard about Carvana through friends, so I thought I'd give it a try. It was easy. I input information about the car, including the mileage, the VIN number.
Answered a few questions and got a real offer in seconds.
It felt too good to be true. It was a lot higher than I expected. A Carvana advocate came to my house. As soon as they accepted my car, they paid me on the spot. I couldn't believe it.
I recommend it to anyone. Try it for yourself. Go to Carvana.com and get an offer for your car. At Carvana.
Whoa.
What if it all looks good? What if I can't decide?
Dulce de leche.
No, what if I can't decide the right coverage?
At State Farm, we're there for your what ifs. Oh.
Thank you.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
Indiana Jones. Always knew someday you'd come walking back through my door.
Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes?
X marks the spot.
I'm calling the Cover Girls.
Hey, Queen, you're back.
I'm back. I hear Lash Blast is your favorite mascara.
It sure is. Try it.
10 times more volume.
Mega.
Lash Blast volume.
From easy, breezy, beautiful CoverGirl.
Today's Capital One rewarding performance came courtesy of switch hitting veteran Riley Burcham. Grad transfer from Michigan, drove in two with two outs in the fifth inning. That gave Clemson the lead. And he got another run home with a safety squeeze in the seventh.
rewarding performances. Plural today for Riley Bertram.
Here's Benjamin Blackwell. 1 for 3 today. And it's fouled straight back. Another final. Indiana State came from behind to escape Wright State for a 6-5 victory for the Sycamores. They trailed by 2 in the bottom of the 8th. Came back and won it. Past the diving Coppedge off of his glove. And Blackwell's got his second hit.
Got a slider and just stayed on it. Can pull those hands in to get the barrel to it. Coppedge almost made a big-time play. Was to it, just misjudged the hop a little bit off the top of his glove. Clemson's got the leadoff man on in the 8th. Now we're going to discuss things.
Jack Crichton is due up. Elsewhere, upsets today. Washington beat DBU. Texas Tech won against UConn. Oregon held on to win against Xavier. And Maryland topped Northeastern. Crichton's spot is due up. Max Starbuck is going to get a chance to hit, it looks like. And that'll cause a visit to the mound from Jeff Forehand.
I think we're just talking strategy right here to see if he squares, this is what we're going to do. Talk about the bunt defense right here, potentially if he runs, which Blackwell does plenty. He's 25 of 31 on the year, so it doesn't need to be just a straight sack bunt here. Fake bunt steal, put him in motion, try to get the defense moving at the same time.
Starbuck is a junior from Easley. Enters with one on and nobody out. He's made 3 starts in the season, but this is only his 12th game played. Late March, came up with a big pinch hit double against Georgia Tech. He squares early. Starbuck's working towards an advanced degree. He graduated last May. Came out of Easley High School. Will Hoy coming in from third. Pulled away on the bunt. Did it hit the bat?
I think it missed the bat. Kelly just couldn't. He got glove on it, just not in glove, so clearly squared. I think it was a called fake bunt. On that one, all you gotta do is bunt strikes. If it's out of the zone, pull it back. Does right there. Blackwell now standing at second base. See if they do it again. Goes to stolen base. It may have been a fake bunt steal the whole time.
Corner is cheating. Starbuck gets this one down. It was coming right to his chest. The throw is dug out over at first by Lundgren. Great play Sacrifice gets Blackwell 90 feet away from another Clemson run.
That's a really good bunt right there. One that Starbuck, maybe if he had to do it again, pull that bat back, he'd get into a 2-0 count. But instead, even with this ball coming in on his hands, deadens it perfectly and makes it a tough play for Ethan Smith. You said a Lundgren really picked him up, too. That was not an easy one to go get. It looks like Lipscomb will go to that bullpen.
Yep, that'll be it for Ethan Smith. Ending in a third in relief of Logan Van Treek, their ace. And with the top of the order due up, Bisons will go back to the bullpen. We'll tell you about the new guy after this.
Your house is lovely.
Thank you. I need to introduce you to someone. He was telling me how Geico makes it easy to save on homeowners insurance, so I was thinking...
Will.
Hello, old friend.
So you have met.
Years ago, we both had big dreams about saving people money on their homeowners insurance.
Yeah, just look at us now.
Your house is lovely.
Yeah, I just said that.
Okay, nobody heard you.
Okay.
I did hear you.
Geico makes it easy to save on homeowners insurance.
I love hot food.
Unlock a fresh take on dinner. Ziploc. Unlock life. SC Johnson. See Disney and Pixar's Elemental in theaters June 16th.
This delectable ramen noodle recipe will put an end to your drive-thru dinner rituals. Throw that powder in that tasty combo of delightful carrots and the rich touch of bok choy. Norte's Combos. It's not fast food, but it's so good.
The course, Jack, built.
Oh my goodness, go in!
Jack is the man.
It's action-packed. It's adrenaline-filled. It's must-watch.
It's going to be special. It's going to be a fun year.
Sunday Night Baseball. Sundays at 7. All season long on ESPN.
Here's Hayden Frank, 6'5", sophomore left-hander out of McMinn County High School in Riceville, Tennessee. Just south of Knoxville by about an hour. 25th appearance, 3-2 with an ERA of 1.5. Nearly a 5-1 strikeout to walk ratio.
He has been their best out of the bullpen this year. It's a low 90s fastball and a really good curveball. Threw a few changeups to righties sometimes too, but the reason that he's in the game right now, he's been great against lefties all year, and he's got lefty coming up at the top of this Clemson order.
It'll be Cam Caminella to start. Caminella struck out his first two trips to the plate, singled and scored in the fifth. ACC Freshman of the Year. Caminella singled and scored in the fifth. And he sends this one in the air to the left side. Ketchup's got it. Two down. And now Cooper Engel. Engel scored a couple of times today. And he sends a shot through the right side. Split the fielders, and Engel drives in one.
Yeah, Clemson's been really good runners in scoring position today. They've done it a few different ways. A few sack bunts. Bryce hit one of the seats, but this time Cooper Engel not wasting any time. First two hitters to come in and face a left-hander have swung at the first pitch. Shift was on, but hit it right where they weren't right there. And that adds another one for Clemson here in the eighth. Solo runs in the seventh and the eighth to extend the lead.
You wanted to say ain't, didn't you?
I did, and then my tongue became tied.
I would have
hit it where they ain't. That's what I meant.
And he hit them where they went. Taylor's got a base hit and a couple of runs. Clemson 3-for-9 with runners in scoring position. Lipscomb just 1-for-10. And the two-out hitting has been impressive. Tigers 5-for-12. Fouled off. So we have an addition to Balloon Woman behind home plate. We've got call him Balloon Man. He really looks like that inflatable out front of the used car lot, though, when he gets going. Bolt foul. Yeah.
Balloon Man looked like he was about to take a digger right there. The old footing's a little iffy back behind home plate. He starts early, makes some adjustments.
Not judging, but I feel like this isn't the first time he's ever been wobbly.
Notice how everybody around him just cleared out.
That's right.
Nope, give him room.
Let him cook. Doesn't seem as dedicated as Balloon Woman because he's only been doing it for a half inning. She's been doing it for eight.
We're shooting arrows. You got to switch it up.
Were you ever distracted by anything in the crowd?
I don't know that I even would have known. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, oh. No.
Had a good run.
No, to answer your question, no. I was just kind of torn up about Balloon Lady losing her prop.
Probably deliver another one to her. Two on and two out. Caden Grice has 37 two-out RBI, including two on his home run in the first inning. That's team's best. So that's 37 of his 66. You expect we see Grice on the mound tomorrow?
Yep, just thinking the same thing. I do. One of the best two-way players in the country. But it really seems like it's between him and Caglione for the John Olerud Award, which is given out to best two-way player in Division I.
Oh, man, that was close. First baseman Lundgren wouldn't even hold him on. And try to sneak in behind Taylor.
That's pretty good work by Taylor right there, because you're not expecting to see that one.
Lipscomb wants to challenge it, and they could use it to end the inning. Tag was applied right on top of his head.
I thought the call was accurate, but you might as well use it right here. There's no reason not to. Even that right hand kind of stuck in the dirt a little bit going back to first, but it looked like it got back there in time before the tag was applied.
How does this work between Frank and Lundgren to get the timing right?
In that case, Frank is going whenever he wants to, and Lundgren's going on first move. So you got to make sure you're close enough. You got to play deep enough, and so the base runner doesn't feel like anything's going on, but close enough that you can get over there. So all the timing is keyed off of the pitcher in that one. The minute he raises his foot, then Lundgren's going to break to first and ideally get there right when the ball did. They timed it well. It was just really heads up by Will Taylor to get back in time.
Collaborative replay being run out of Pittsburgh. And Caden Grice waiting to see the outcome of this one. If he could continue with the 2-0 count, you mentioned his competition for the John Olerud Award, two-way player of the year. Caglione is getting the ball tonight for Florida in their opener. He'd been their game three starter most of the season. 28 home runs, second in the country to Cam Fisher, who we will see in game two against Charlotte. So the inning continues, 2-0 to Grice.
Good take there. You're sitting fastball. That one started in a spot that it would have been a strike. Grice lets it go. 2-0 breaking ball misses. I think you're turning him loose 3-0 right here.
Yeah.
It's a fastball. He may try to hit it over the batting cages in right field.
Takes ball four. And the Tigers have loaded the bases against Hayden Frank here in the eighth. Opportunity for Billy Amick. Ingles at third, Taylor at second, and Grice at first. They've all reached with two outs. Billy Amick led the ACC in hitting. .418 average through the regular season. 12 home runs. 1-0. Whoa. Kelly had to sprawl after that one. Amick's 3-for-7 with the bases loaded this season, including a grand slam. Fly ball, right field, and deep. Lee is back. It's gone. Grand slam, Amick out of the roof. His second grand slam of the season. Clemson has blown this thing wide open.
For the guy that led the ACC in hitting this year, he had been quiet until right there today. Plus count elevated fastball rides that wind out to right center field. He knew it was gone right away. Will Lee knew it was gone as he got closer to the wall, and it's a grand slam that extends that Clemson lead. It's now 12-5 Tigers.
Here's Riley Bertram, and he bangs one up the middle. Cajun Cafe doesn't just smoke the meat. They got smoke bombs for home runs, and Bertram makes it a double. Surprised them.
Done that a few times today. Not afraid to try to take the extra 90, especially again right there when Lipscomb a little bit back on their heels. I mean, this is a routine ground ball up the middle that Riley Bertram turned into a double. Look at that. I mean, he even put the brakes on a little bit, then just noticed that things were moving a little bit slower in the outfield.
Jeff Forehand hurries his way out to the mound. How do you feel about smoke bombs in the outfield?
I think it's a nice touch. I mean, it looks like they're coming out of those things you used to launch bottle rockets out of, too. Light the bottle rocket, drop it all the way down in there, and then out she comes.
Very Premier League of them. And Lipscomb's going to head back to the bullpen. The lead is now 7.
NCAA and its member schools offer nearly 500,000 college athletes a path to go pro in something other than sports. Learn more at NCAA.org.
Run campaign commercial. It's a great deal. A large coffee and a donut for a buck. I mean, it's pretty cool. So I thought it'd be like authentic and meta. Yes, I'm doing the commercial, but am I doing the commercial? You know, I'll do commercials. You know, I'm a real actor. This is an art form for me.
I do know you departed.
Departed.
You, were you in the department?
I'm Matt Damon.
No, yeah, I love him. I love him.
Some of his work.
He's got a really consistent career, I think.
Yeah.
Time for a Dunkin' Run. Get a $1 donut with any medium or larger coffee.
Tyler Legere will take over on the mound for Lipscomb, trying to stop the bleeding here. A 5-run eighth already. And all of it coming with two outs.
I think some of this, too, if you're Lipscomb, if you're going to come back through the loser's bracket, which it looks like they're going to have to do, you're going to need Hayden Frank. So bring him in high leverage. Didn't work. Get him out of there so you could still bring him in at some point tomorrow.
Jeers from Madison, Alabama. Came out of James Clemens High School and went to Calhoun County Community College. He's got Blake Wright at the plate. The sidearmer misses up and away. Legere hasn't allowed a run over his last two outings, including one against Florida Gulf Coast in the A-Sun tournament. Wright is the ninth batter of this inning for Clemson. Tigers now 7-for-14 with two outs. One jammed him, and Berg will take care of it, but not before Clemson sends 9 to the plate and five runs in the 8th.
The NCAA baseball regionals are presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Ooh. Indiana Jones. Always knew someday you'd come walking back through my door.
Snakes. Why did it have to be snakes?
X marks the spot.
Wow, look at these seats. They're great.
Yeah, kind of thought I had the aisle, but...
Hot Nuts popcorn, bundle and save.
Hot Nuts and popcorn and savings. Just like bundling your home and car with Geico.
Yeah, in fact, Hot Nuts are like home insurance.
I get it. The Gecko explained it pretty clearly.
Whoa!
Hey, I know you.
Yeah, hi.
Not you. The guy who helped me bundle my home and car. He's great.
Thanks, mate. I appreciate it.
Probably thought you were somebody else.
Okay.
See how much you could save by bundling with Geico.
Welcome back to Doug Kinsmore Stadium, where Clemson has a 12-5 lead over Lipscomb. And the winner of this one will move to tomorrow night's game at 6 Eastern against the winner of Tennessee and Charlotte. That game will air on ESPNU at 6 Eastern today. Loser this one falls into an elimination game tomorrow. B.J. Bailey is the new pitcher for Clemson, 6'5 lefty out of Woodruff, South Carolina.
Upper 80s fastball, but a plus curveball for Bailey over the course of the year. Clemson has now used 5 arms today. But really, aside from the starter, Austin Gordon, any of the 4 that came out of the bullpen should be good to go tomorrow if they need him. Trying to get Bailey to get the last 3 outs here.
And the first pitch hit to Hall in right field, and he backs up against the fence to make the play. Just entered as a defensive replacement. ESPN is a home for the NCAA College Baseball Regionals. For around-the-clock multi-game coverage, scan the QR code. ESPN Plus subscribers can access expanded coverage with Squeeze Play. First pitch strike to Jake Berg here with 1 out of the 9th inning and the last chance for Lipscomb. Breaking ball for a swing and a miss, and Lipscomb down to its last out.
Fastballs to start, then it gets Berg all the way out in front. An efficient 2 outs so far for the left-hander.
Here's Parks Bauk. He is 1-for-4 in this one. And this ball is lined to left field. 2 out shot. He's looking for a double. And we'll go in with an extra base hit on a ball that came off of his bat at 106 miles an hour. And now David Coppedge.
Riley Bertram trying to deke him right here, too. He was standing straight up at the end just to see if that ball was going to get there. But
nothing in 1 to Coppedge. And Lipscomb down to its last strike. Strike 3 called. Bailey cleans it up with 2 strikeouts in the 9th inning. Clemson will advance to the winner's side and an elimination game tomorrow at noon for the A-Sun regular season and tournament champs from Lipscomb.
The ASUN champs made it uncomfortable for Clemson, but then we started showing up late. 3 1/5. One in the seventh, and then a 5-run 8th, thanks in large part to the Billy Amick grand slam to right center field. And Clemson, it's a little time off. They won't play until late in the day tomorrow.
Clayton got the win to go to 8-0. Ventrique, yeoman's effort for him. He suffered the loss to fall to 8-5. Clemson will await the winner of Charlotte and Tennessee. And we'll have that game for you tomorrow night. But first, one more today on ESPNU. When we return, it'll be Tennessee and Charlotte.
Should be good tonight. Should be real good tonight. Now, crowd's going to be a little bit different, but that's one thing. Tennessee, not going to see quite as much orange in the stands as we saw during this. But for Charlotte, you get to see the nation's home run leader against the pitching staff in Tennessee that is as good as really any in the entire country. Ton of swing and miss. Andrew Lindsay on the mound tonight for Tennessee will face his old team. Transfer from Charlotte.
Now, if they could just get the smoke bombs to smell like the meat that they're smoking, we'd have a winner.
That'd be a good combo. Yeah. There's no new Pope. That's not what it is. It's something totally different.
There's a new second baseman, though, for this Clemson team. A guy who's got plenty of postseason experience. Played in the College World Series finals with Michigan in 2019. And he's seen, by the way, three of his teammates from that team, or two of them so far, make it to the big leagues, and a third right around the corner. He's kind enough to join us now. Riley Bertram's got the headset on down the right field line. Hey, Riley, we were just talking about your success when we saw you in Omaha with Michigan in 2019. How valuable is that experience on a day like today and a weekend like this?
Yeah, it's definitely valuable to be on that team my freshman year, and to see those seniors and the juniors that was their last year, to see how they went about their business and, you know, played each play. But, you know, this is a new group of guys that are hungry to have success in the postseason, and it was awesome to see everyone come in and then get settled in and then finally make that big punch in the eighth.
Right, like we've talked about kind of the two seasons that you guys had. I mean, start 17-13 or 14, whatever it was, and you've been as good as anybody in the country since then. I mean, you're new to this year. What was your role when it was to that point of, hey, man, we're 2-8 in the league and it's go time?
You know, just keeping the guys in it. These guys were believers. They're fighters. They weren't going to go down easy as a team and as a unit. But for the most part, you know, just like I said, first place, just, you know, keep everyone in it, keeping the belief in the locker room. And it was, you know, it's exciting to see us go on that winning streak and, you know, really get everyone to have that true belief and then see everyone perform out here on the field.
Hey, before we let you go, you know, your head coach who recruited you to Michigan, then brought you down here to Clemson, said that you've got the it factor, that he would hire you at some point once you get another degree. If it's not baseball, what's it going to be for Riley Bertram?
I don't know. Not looking into that too much right now. We got a lot of business to take care of this season and, you know, goals to accomplish. So.
No doubt about it. Thanks, man. We appreciate it. Good luck tomorrow night.
Awesome. Thanks, sir.
Riley Bertram and the Clemson Tigers with a 12-5 victory over Lipscomb thanks to a 5-run 8th inning. Offensive night for a day for both, I should say. Lipscomb hit 3 home runs in this game but come up short. It'll be Tennessee and Charlotte in the 2-3 game, 6 o'clock Eastern. We'll see you then, not only on the ESPN app, but also on ESPNU. Lipscomb will be on the field again tomorrow at noon. Face the loser of this one in an elimination game. More orange in the ballpark. The Volunteers from the SEC are here. They'll put Andrew Lindsay on the mound. We'll get that covered in just 2.5 hours from now. Once again, our final, Clemson over Lipscomb, 12-5. For Kyle Peterson, our fantastic crew here at Clemson, see you in just a minute.
Is that a robot?
We're just work friends.
We're trying to stop the end of the world.
The world's ending?
60-40.
On June 9th, you've never faced anything like this.
Team up.